The NFC East, the most powerful division of the 80s and early 90s, produced some of the most memorable games of our time. Now a new guard has emerged in this division, and today the Redskins and Eagles battle in what could be another classic. Welcome to a gorgeous day in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Donovan McNabb announced to the crowd. Huge ovation. The Eagles gather at midfield, and we have a matchup here at Lincoln Financial Field with the surprising Washington Redskins off to a 3-1 start, taking on the surprising Philadelphia Eagles off to a 1-2 start. Somewhere up here with the real bright lights, Joe Buck, Troy Aikman, and Chris Collinsworth. What's up? What a week it's been, Mr. Aikman, for Donovan McNabb. I mean, everything that he's been going through, the controversy, and now here he is trying to lead this team back to the 500 mark.
Yeah, he got caught in the middle of a firestorm this week through no fault of his own. And you talk to Donovan McNabb, and he just wants to go play, which is what he was able to do last week. He's hoping it can carry over to this week, but it can't all be about Donovan McNabb. Some of these other players have got to step up. Too often they wait for him to make the big play. Todd Pinkston, James Thrash, Brian Westbrook, those guys have got to be able to make some plays to help take the pressure off Donovan today.
I'm just going to talk about football. Is that all right? It's kind of hard to do this week.
You're allowed. You know? It's okay.
On the defensive side of the ball, though, for the Philadelphia Eagles, a lot of young guys going to get in today. Lito Shepard, Sheldon Brown, three Pro Bowlers missing out of that defensive secondary. And it's a point that wasn't lost on Steve Spurrier. He's recognized it. So for all the running that Steve Spurrier has done in the beginning part of this season, don't expect it today. He's going to test these guys in the secondary.
And the guy that's going to be winging it around the lot is young Patrick Ramsey. And I at least came away very impressed with the young man, and he is off to a fantastic start.
Well, he really is, and it's hard to believe that here is a young man who is making only his 10th NFL start, and he looks like he's been playing in this league for about 10 years. He's made a lot of big-time throws. And the one thing, however, is though he's leading the league in sacks. He's been hit a lot. That's a concern. But the one thing about it, Chris, is that he's got a lot of weapons on that offensive side of the ball.
That they really didn't have it a season ago. If you know anything at all about Steve Spurrier, he wants big plays. He always has, whether he's in college or in the pros. And now he has guys that can deliver those big plays. Lavernius Coles, Trunk Candidate. And this offense right now looks more like a Steve Spurrier style of offense, certainly than anything we saw last year.
Well, you've got a great profile. Anybody ever tell you that? Remember to answer the Sprint virtual coach question. You can use this, your Sprint PCS Vision phone, or log on to foxsports.com. We get ready for football here in Philadelphia, and we're glad you're with us today on Fox. They've already had the coin toss while we were up here rapping at each other. And I'm going to assume that the Washington Redskins won the toss because they are about to receive. So we will get the early look at Patrick Ramsey, or as his head coach Steve Spurrier calls him, J. Patrick, for absolutely no reason. It's a little windy here. Winds out of the northwest, 15 to 20 miles per hour. Should be fun. Eagles and Redskins. Chad Morton took it from inside the five, has room to run. He is out to the 30 and beyond. They'll mark him down at the 31, and that's where the Washington Redskins offense will start. He said, look, my name's Patrick Allen Ramsey, yet my head coach Steve Spurrier calls me J. Patrick because he knows a lot of Joseph Patricks. And so J. Patrick is in the huddle, number two in the NFL with that yardage. Number two to Tommy Maddox of all quarterbacks. First down for the Redskins. Little play action to start. A test of that secondary, and the pass is too high for Royal, the tight end. Had him absolutely wide open, and Ramsey, a little charged up, overshoots him.
I think you look at Patrick Ramsey and what he's been able to accomplish. 5-1 over his last six starts. And I think there's a tendency, because of the poise that he's shown early in this season, to forget the fact that he's only in his second NFL season.
So poised, in fact, that he's got his mouthpiece on top of his face mask. Second down and 10. Ramsey hurried, had some time initially, and then fired it into the ground in the direction of Bryan Johnson as fullback. It's third and 10.
Well, we've got an interesting matchup of defensive backs against wide receivers here. In this game, Lito Shepard, the number one pick out of Florida, is going to go up against Lavernius Coles. They're going to follow each other all over the field. On the other side, Sheldon Brown, who's a little bit bigger, stronger, more physical guy, will go up against Rod Gardner. That's probably going to decide this ball game today, how those two matchups go.
A blitz. Ramsey in a ton of trouble, dumps it off. Short of the first down is Candidate as he's knocked down at the 35, and it's three and out for the Redskins.
Well, Jim Johnson said that he was going to bring pressure against this Washington Redskin offense. You got Sheldon Brown right here, the left corner. He's going to come in on the corner blitz. Patrick Ramsey has got to be able to see that. He doesn't see it. Fortunately for him, though, he's able to get the ball out in time.
The one thing Jim Johnson does so well, though, is disguise those blitzes. You're never quite sure where they're coming from.
Brian Barker hangs it up, and it's Westbrook, who does a little bit of everything for this Philadelphia team with a fair catch. And the Eagles offense will start with it at their own 24. Let's go back out to Los Angeles and check in with JB.
Hey, fellas, take a look at this. This is not a replay of last week. Look at Dante Hall. Outstanding moves from there, 93 yards, that punt return for a score. Fourth consecutive game for him with a touchdown. That's a new NFL record. Denver wins it. And Sebastian Janikowski, despite five field goals, he missed a point after, came back to haunt the Raiders as Edinger hit a 48-yarder, Chicago's first victory of the season. Back to you guys, Joe Buck.
All right, JB, thanks. Quick pass is out to their young tight end, L.J. Smith. He makes some moves and picks up seven.
I think it's worth noting in today's game, Donovan McNabb, who banged his thumb in last week's win over Buffalo, is playing with a wrapped-up thumb. Watching him in warm-ups today, it did not appear that it would be a factor, something to keep an eye on as we move through this game.
Second down and three. Blitz coming from Arrington. The Eagles pick it up, and diving out of bounds with a first down is Westbrook. Take a look at the offense for the Philadelphia Eagles. And you look at that offensive line, three Pro Bowlers from a year ago. They have Thrash and Pinkston on the outside, and we'll see all three running backs, Staley, Buckhalter, and Westbrook, and it's hard to believe that Donovan McNabb has not thrown a touchdown pass yet. First down, that's Westbrook. Gain of only one, and we look at the defense for the Washington Redskins. George Edwards, the defensive coordinator, who Spurrier met while at Duke, deserves a lot of credit for putting together a good start to this season with this group. But guys, I know you love their cornerbacks.
Well, Champ Bailey, when you look at him, he's one of the best there is in the game, and he's a guy who goes with the opponent's best receiver. Today, you can bet that he's going to be going with James Thrash as he is right now.
Now they switch off, so not man-to-man, and the pass is dumped off. Westbrook, good tackle. Coming up to make the play was Champ Bailey. No gain on the play, and it's third down and nine coming up.
I think on that play, it looked like the Eagles were hoping to use the motion to get Champ Bailey on the other side. The Redskins defensively that time just checked to a zone as soon as the motion came, so Champ Bailey was right there to make the tackle. But I want to agree with you, Troy. I tell you what, watching Champ Bailey on film last week, I think not only is he one of the best defensive backs in the game, I think he's one of the best players in the National Football League right now.
On third down, McNabb steps up. Penalty flag on the play. McGann's got a first down into open field. Flag on the play. Nice cutback down to the 10, but the Redskins are indicating that this is against Philadelphia. And it is. That will negate a 54-yard run by Donovan McNabb.
And that was a design scramble by Donovan McNabb. A quarterback draw. He comes back three steps. But they got the hold. Looked like it might have been John Runyon, the right tackle, that's going to get called for it.
holding offense. Number 89, 10-yard penalty, repeat third down.
There's a penalty right here. It's going to be on Chad Lewis.
Good call, but I tell you what, for Donovan McNabb, same way he started the game last week with a nice run to kind of wake him up, get him back on track, and I still think that for him, this is the right formula. This seems to get Donovan in the game more than anything else, more than getting hit, more than completing a long pass, more than when he comes up with a nice long run early in the ball game, he seems to get into a flow like no other.
After the penalty, it's third and 19. Jumping it off Westbrook and brought down well short of a first down. Knocked down at the 35 in time for the Eagles to punt. What LeVar Arrington tell us yesterday? If Donovan McNabb beats us while he's in the pocket, then they deserve to win. Well, it's their focus to keep him in there.
Absolutely, and they didn't do a very good job right there. The thing about it is Chad Lewis did not have to hold there. Donovan McNabb was already up inside of that.
The punt coming from Dirk Johnson. And it takes a bounce out of bounds. They're going to mark it at the 28. So decent field position for the Washington offense. No score early in Philly.
Remember how great the last day of school was? That's what getting away on a Southwest Airlines Fun Fare feels like. They're everyday low fares to your favorite vacation spots that start at just $49.
You are now free to move about the country.
Spicy garlic and lime shrimp, fire grilled chicken, and our famous tangy baby back ribs, all in one sizzling platter. Chili's fajita trio. Want more flavor?
Chili's!
It silenced the skeptics. It defied the laws of physics. It tested the limits of human ingenuity. What will it do next? Introducing the new LS from Lexus.
Fox NFL Sunday is brought to you by Southwest Airlines. Friendly nonstop service all across the country. Southwest Airlines, a symbol of freedom.
What's going on in the NFC East, you ask? Well, as Washington and Philadelphia play here, Dallas won. They took care of the Cardinals. They're now 3-1.
Come on, give a little cheer. Go ahead.
My boys. I mean, when that score flashed across, Chris, did you see the look on Troy's face? Just like a proud pop.
But my Bengals blew it again.
I'm with you, no. Bill Parcells. I've always loved you. On first down, over the middle, and off the hands of Lavernius Coles, incomplete. Who are these guys on offense? Now the mouthpiece is in the face mask, not on top. For Patrick Ramsey, this offensive line, Troy's been taking some hits in the public.
Yeah, they really have, because Ramsey's been getting hit a lot, so people immediately equate that to the fact that the offensive line isn't getting it done, and that's really not the case. There's been a lot of audibles, a lot of miscommunication in the backfield, and so it's freed guys up, but this offensive line's played better than most people think.
Ramsey over the middle has Gardner, and Rod Gardner is fighting, brought down close to first down yardage, and with the spot it looks like he got it. And we look at this defense, they have one guy after another go down with injury, whether it's up front across the defensive line or in the secondary, and they are without three of their usual starters back there.
And I thought Jim Johnson, the defensive coordinator, did one of his best jobs ever, and he's done a lot of great ones around here last week. With all those guys out and injured, this defense really stepped up against Buffalo.
And off
is to Kennedy. He gets it out to the 40. Gain of two. And I guess the question is, and maybe it was answered in that initial drive, with that young, inexperienced secondary, will that force Jim Johnson to back off some of the blitzes? And I would say so far the answer is no.
Well, I think Jim Johnson's going to mix it up pretty good. On that last play, he was playing coverage, trying to stop the run with seven-man front. And I think this is going to be a real chess match between Jim Johnson and then Steve Spurrier.
Second down and eight. Ramsey has plenty of time and finds his man. Out of the backfield is Rock Cartwright, and he is spinning forward for a first down.
You know, anytime you play against Mike Martz of the Rams or Steve Spurrier, they are not going to try and pass protect. So you're going to end up giving up some sacks. It is going to be just like this, five-man protection, seven-step drops. You don't see a lot of it, but you're also going to have to face all these guys coming out on the route. And it's just a difference of philosophy. Some coaches like to protect. Spurrier likes to get them out.
Toss to Kennedy. Lowers his head and gets it to the 49-yard line of the Eagles, brought down by Simino.
Yeah, and that's a guy that they're really happy that they were able to bring in. Mark Simino with a trade with Atlanta. And he has been everything that they had hoped that he would be. We've got Nate Wayne, another key acquisition for the Eagles this year from Green Bay, down on the field.
I'm sure the Eagles and Jim Johnson saying, who's next? They're asking for volunteers along the sideline. Hopefully Wayne's not hurt badly.
It was fast. We met it faster. It was smart. We made it smarter. Until it was as close to perfect as it's ever come. And that's saying something. Introducing the new, more powerful ES-330.
Today, more than 250,000 doctors and 75 million patients are redefining modern medicine with WebMD. Practices can attend to the business of medicine with new speed and efficiency. Doctors can continue their medical education without leaving their offices. Patients can monitor their own progress. In countless ways, WebMD is helping doctors and patients to reconnect, and in the process, helping to redefine modern medicine. WebMD, modern medicine.
Hey, Donovan! Surprise!
It's not my yard.
If you really want tickets to the game, just use your Visa. It's the card you know they'll take everywhere you want to be. Visa.
Hey, you!
Proud sponsor of the NFL.
Don't miss the hit series critics are calling as brilliant as anything on TV. Nip Tuck. This week, only on FX. Fox NFL Sunday is brought to you by Visa. If you love the NFL, it's everywhere you want to be.
We welcome you back. Nate Wayne is just now making his way across the field. And the odd thing is, when you look at it on the replay, the only thing you might see is that right knee right there. He even stays on his feet and gets in at the end of the tackle on Candidate, but he's having a tough time getting across the field.
I mean, it is just unbelievable the number of injuries this team has endured. Their number one pick, Jerome McDougal, Derek Burgess, Paul Grass-Manis, Troy Vincent, Bobby Taylor, Brian Dawkins, not to mention the guys they lost in free agency, Hugh Douglas and Sean Barber, who one of the Redskins coaches was telling me before the game, they thought he was their most effective defensive player a season ago.
Mike Reese comes in to take Wayne's spot. And it's second down and eight. Comes a corner blitz again. Ramsey sacked all the way back at the 40, and it's Simino.
Well, they're going to bring a four-week blitz. Again, they bring Sheldon Brown off the corner. They do a good job of picking that up, but they don't pick up Mark Simino up the inside. And last week against Buffalo, this Philadelphia defense was unable to get much pressure on Drew Bledsoe. And so Jim Johnson knows that in order to get to the quarterback, they've got to start bringing some secondary people, but they've got to time their spots. They don't want to expose this young group in the secondary too often today.
Third down and 17. Another blitz and the throw. The pass is tipped and it's incomplete. And there are no flags on the play.
Tell you what, Patrick Ramsey is going to take a severe beating today if he's going to sit back there and try and move around in the pocket and avoid some of these blitzes. Right now, if you're Jim Johnson, you're not going to be sending fewer blitzes. You're going to be sending more because the Redskins simply have not been able to come up with an answer for it, and the receivers are not getting open down the field in the man coverage.
Another punt from Barker. Westbrook from inside the 15. Penalty flag on this return as Westbrook is out across the 40. We'll check the flag. That's Patrick Ramsey hurting. I was just going to say, Troy, what's the first question you ask these quarterbacks when they sit down with us?
When they've been hit as much as what he has, you know, how you feeling? He said, I feel great. But you look right here, he's not feeling so good, and it looked like he landed.
Illegal block in the back. Receiving team number 51. 10-yard penalty. He keeps the ball, first down.
Joe, it looked like when he fell to the ground following that hit that he may have done something to his shoulder. It looks like it could even be a broken collarbone the way that he's moving around on the sidelines. As you see, he lands right on his left shoulder, and that's where they're checking him over on the sidelines.
Gina, check this out. I'm sitting next to your new boyfriend. Don't you just love your new boyfriend?
I do love him.
As long as you're happy.
Picture mail that talks from Sprint. At Sprint stores, choose from a wide selection of picture phones starting at $99.99. Share it when it happens.
This fall, Bristol-Myers Squibb, the cancer community, and I will come together for a very special campaign called the Tour of Hope. We want to raise awareness of clinical trials and let people know that cancer research is worth the ride. I've had this relationship with Bristol-Myers Squibb for years now because if it wasn't for BMS drugs, I just would not be sitting here today. Together, we can speed the search for a cure.
Follow the Bristol-Myers Squibb Tour of Hope team and Lance Armstrong in this historic ride. Find out more by visiting our website.
What you seeing didn't start with LL today. Take it from me, Run DMC paved the way with Jam Master J, the K-I-N-G's. Run D and Dr. Pepper, that's originality. The taste of Dr. Pepper.
Dr. Pepper.
The taste of originality. Salutes individuality.
Individual.
Gives life personality. Be you, do what you do.
Be you.
Be you, nothing better than Dr. Pepper. Run DMC and Jam Dr. Pepper.
I just want to run away.
His father is the district attorney.
He wants to destroy my business.
You tell your son to keep his filthy hands off my daughter.
You cannot see this girl again ever.
What have I done?
I love you.
I love you too.
Skin premieres Monday, October 20th on Fox.
Sacked 15 times coming into this game. Hit hard already in this game. Ramsey is up, throwing the ball on the sideline as the Eagles take it. And the pass is out of the reach of the fullback, Richie. You know, you go back and you take a look at the hit on Patrick Ramsey, and he gets hit several times right here. But I think it's that blow right there, along with going down to the ground. Of course, Ike Reese involved in that, and Darwin Walker landed on top of him. He's throwing on the sidelines. It appears that he will be going back in the game, but he's definitely in some discomfort. Second down and 10 for the Eagles. No score here in the first quarter. McNabb fires. He has Westbrook. And Bryan's out of bounds with a Philadelphia first down.
You know, Westbrook came up with that huge play last week, running for the touchdown to break the game open against the Bills. And I really think that they need to play him more. This Philadelphia offense really doesn't have much big play capability. They don't have a touchdown pass this season. And this guy has the ability to break a game open. And I think as the season progresses, we're going to see more and more of Westbrook in the game.
Stanley held out. He's only rushed for 35 yards this season coming into this game. It's Buckhalter in the backfield, and McNabb is flushed and fires out of bounds. Big pressure by Holsey for the Washington Redskins. And we look ahead. The MLB playoffs on Fox and what's coming your way. Congratulations to the Boston Red Sox coming from behind with runs in the bottom of the eighth inning to defeat the Oakland A's. Their game five is coming up tomorrow, but the big one is tonight. And that is Kerry Wood and the Chicago Cubs taking on Mike Hampton and the Atlanta Braves. 7:30 Eastern right here on Fox. There's that Boston score in the upper right-hand corner of your screen. Handoff is to Westbrook. Bryan is out to the 30. Let's go down to the sideline and check in with Pam Oliver.
Well, Joe, you see quarterback Patrick Ramsey throwing on the sidelines. The Redskins tell me he has a bruised left shoulder. He will return. Back to you.
They're just digging at that thing underneath his shoulder pad.
He's a tough guy, though. It's one of the things they really respect about him, and one of the reasons they drafted him out of Tulane. He took a lot of hits down there, kept getting up off the turf, never complained, wasn't a particularly good team, and that was one of the things they really liked about him.
Third down and five for the Eagles. Blitz coming from the Redskins, and the pass is incomplete, and a penalty flag comes in at the end of the play. L.J. Smith, the intended receiver, and they're going to call roughing the passer against Washington. LeVar Arrington is pleading his case.
Personal foul, roughing the passer, defense number 50. Lowered his head and hit the quarterback. 15-yard penalty, first down.
League-high 44th penalty for the Redskins.
Well, as you can see right there, I mean, he hits him in the chest. He didn't even come to the headgear. I can understand why LeVar Arrington is upset about that.
Oh, my.
I tell you, I know that they're trying to do everything they can to protect these quarterbacks and keep them in the game and playing healthy, but, boy, they have really taken it to a whole different level trying to protect them. I don't know exactly what LeVar Arrington could have done. Not only did he not hit him in the helmet, but he let up right before he got there.
That's a terrible call. And instead of a punt coming from Philadelphia, they get a first down at their own 45. McNabb over the middle, has a man, and the pass is caught. That's Smith.
Well, it's been a long way back for L.J. Smith from opening day when he dropped that pass against the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. It really could have changed that game around. Troy, looks just like sort of a four vertical kind of a route, getting guys down the field. And if you have any doubts about whether Donovan McNabb can ever be a pocket passer, watch this laser shot.
Well, they sure like L.J. Smith, and you're right, little down on him after what happened in opening weekend, but they think he's a guy who can get vertical and get down the field just like he was able to there. He gave Donovan a great lane to throw him the ball.
McNabb hands off to Buckhalter. And there's a loss of one on that play. Let's go back out to Los Angeles. It's a game break, and here's JB.
Hey, fellas, take a look. Boston was down 4-3 in the bottom of the eighth. Joe, it was David Ortiz, 0-16 in the series. Smacks that two-run double with two outs in the bottom of the eighth. Nomar Garcia-Parra, Manny Ramirez scores. Boston wins at 5-4. Game five tomorrow in this transcontinental series will be at 4 or 8 Eastern time on Fox. Back to Joe Buck.
JB, thanks. Hit from behind is McNabb. That ball's up for grabs, and it drops untouched. Reagan Upshaw got the hit on Donovan McNabb.
Reagan Upshaw, of course, brought in. He played with Oakland last year, and he's working against Trey Thomas at the top of the screen, and Trey just doesn't get his feet moved. As a result, Reagan Upshaw able to work around him. And if there's one area where Donovan McNabb seems to get a lot of pressure, it's on that backside when he's not stepping up. Of course, we remember in the championship game with Simeon Rice and some of the plays that he was able to make with Tampa.
McNabb looked like he's limping a little bit out there.
Took a hit two plays ago. And he swings it out to Westbrook, who is hit immediately. And there is Champ Bailey. Going backward on this drive. And we go back to the hit that
caused a limp by McNabb. And that's Pepe Zellner taking him to the ground. And, you know, again, not a hit that looked like it would cause much damage, but he's been moving around pretty gingerly since that time.
This will be a 52-yard try, well within the range of David Akers, who has a career-long this season of 57 yards. It's drilled, and it's good. During the pregame warm-ups, David Akers hit from 67 yards to this direction of the field. This one from 57. This is like an extra point for him. The most accurate and active field goal kicker in Eagles history puts him up by three.
Leon, your reactions following today's devastating loss.
Football's a team sport, man. So I got to put the loss squarely on the shoulders of my supporting cast. Look, man, I've been carrying these guys the whole season, but I can't do it all. I need some help.
So your four fumbles weren't a factor in your mind?
Not if one of those other guys would have jumped on the ball. Again, Leon can't do everything.
There's no I in team.
Well, there ain't no we either.
Circuit City's the place for DirecTV. Stop by today and get up to three rooms free, including installation and a $50 Circuit City gift card after mail-in rebate when you activate any Total Choice programming package. And right now at Circuit City, make the most of DirecTV Entertainment when you upgrade any receiver to DirecTV DVR with TiVo for just $99.99. Circuit City, we're with you.
Is it a marvel of engineering? A triumph of technology? Or a new benchmark of design? Yes. Introducing the new LS from Lexus.
NFL Sunday is brought to you by your Lexus dealer and the new 2004 LS, the ultimate expression of their passionate pursuit. By Circuit City, we're with you. By Budweiser, grab a cold, fresh Budweiser, it's game time. And by Enterprise Rent-A-Car, we'll pick you up.
It's what they're known for around here. Little Philly cheesesteak action as David Akers will kick it away. And this is Morton from the nine. Full head of steam, and he can fly. Good return for the Redskins. Morton out across the 40 and wrestled down at the 42 by Buckhalter. 32-yard return. And all eyes are on Patrick Ramsey. He is healthy enough to go back in there. He will tiptoe back onto the field. He's been hit a lot already.
A whole nickel. Our new XML transaction system saves us a nickel. Wow, a nickel. We save a nickel.
A nickel.
Saving a nickel.
Our new XML transaction system saves us a nickel.
XML what?
We save a nickel on every single transaction.
We do 20 million transactions a month.
With new Windows Server 2003, you can do more with less.
We save a nickel.
You know what you never see in car commercials? Real cars. Cars that have been around the block a few times. The kinds of cars that need Castrol GTX high mileage. Specially engineered to protect against oil burn-off, better than other leading motor oils. Castrol GTX high mileage. It helps older cars feel young again.
Introducing Wendy's Homestyle Chicken Strips.
Heaven, I'm in heaven.
Three delicious pieces of breast fillet. With your choice of Heartland Ranch, Deli Honey Mustard, and Spicy Southwest Chipotle. When it comes to chicken strips,
heaven,
Wendy's has a better way. Our new Homestyle Chicken Strips. It's better here.
I know what I'm having for lunch.
And remember, you can eat great even late.
Come at the
me like that. You gotta act like you wanna hit the dummy, son. And everybody else in line, you gotta act like you wanna hit the dummy. Now hit the back. There you go.
There's Troy Vincent hanging out in a sweatshirt. One of the best in the business. Looking for a new deal around here. He is out with a strain to a hamstring. They hope to have him back next week, and the same for Bobby Taylor. Handoff is to Liddell Betts. A lot of guys around the NFL like this Liddell Betts, second-year player out of Iowa, and a good effort to pick up a five on first down.
Well, he's such a tough runner. I mean, you look at him, and between the tackles, he's very powerful, and he doesn't get that many opportunities because they like to platoon the running backs. They bring in Liddell Betts, they bring in Trunk Canada, but between the two of them, they have both been very productive moving the football and being the big part of this running game.
Four straight 100-yard rushing days for these Redskins. Over the middle, right through the hands of Gardner. Protection on that last throw by Patrick Ramsey, but there hasn't been much so far. He has been getting pounded this season and today.
Well, what happened is they came out and run the ball effectively there on first down and then able to go play action. I think it's the one thing that Steve Spurrier has done this year that he hasn't done much so far this game is run the ball to slow down the pass rush. That's what they're going to have to do today.
That, and they're going to have to keep some backs in to keep him from getting hit because Jim Johnson's going to continually bring one more guy than they can block.
Showing it again. They back out, and Ramsey fires incomplete. That'll bring up fourth down. Gardner, the intended receiver, and we go back to Los Angeles. Another game break. Here's James Brown.
Hey, Joe Buck, take a look at Terrell Owens here. He actually, on this route, a little slant out, slip, got up, caught the ball, 6-yard TD pass from Jeff Garcia. Terrell Owens, you know, wore a surgeon's mask to practice, seeing he didn't want to catch Jeff Garcia's disease. They are back on track. Back to Joe Buck.
James, thanks, as the punt gets away. Barker ends up on his back, and Westbrook hauls it in just outside the 20. Let's go down to the sideline again and hear from Pam Oliver.
Okay, Joe, Eagles defense may be down another body. Linebacker Nate Wayne is in the locker room as we speak. The Eagles tell me Wayne has a right hip strain. His return is questionable. Meanwhile, right guard Jermaine Mayberry has tweaked an earlier injury to his left elbow. It is heavily taped. His return is uncertain at this point. Back to you.
Yeah, for really most of the week, everybody believed Bobby Williams would make the start anyway, and it was kind of a surprise, Troy, that Mayberry was going to play.
Yeah, it was a game day decision, and Bobby Williams came in the third quarter last week and did a really nice job filling in.
Handoff is to Buckhalter, and he picks up one. Uno. Solamente uno. That'll bring up second down and nine.
Well, and Carell Buckhalter, you talk about these running backs and some of the things that the Eagles are doing, platooning some of these guys, Brian Westbrook, Carell Buckhalter, then they bring in Deuce Staley. And a year ago, a lot of people thought Carell Buckhalter was going to be the guy. Of course, he tore his ACL in the first minicamp that they had. That opened the door then for Deuce Staley. Had a great year. Deuce Staley holds out this year, and it's opened the door for Brian Westbrook, who's making the most of it.
Play action to Westbrook, and McNabb's going to run. Donovan McNabb is clotheslined by LeVar Arrington, and it was an Arrington hit, Troy, for you that pretty much ended your career.
Yeah, it was. It was the last hit I took in my NFL career, and it'll be the last Donovan McNabb takes, too, if he doesn't start getting on the ground. Ooh. But if you're going to start running by number 56 for the Redskins, you're going to take some punishment. You got to get to the ground, and, of course, that's not really Donovan's style. And you know, you talk to some of these offensive linemen this week, and they really like the fact that last week when Donovan was in the pocket and decided to start running with the ball, he was very decisive in when he made the decision to go.
Third down and six. Four-man rush for the Redskins, and the pass is complete to Thrash. He's got a first down. You know, I think it's maybe a little overdue to talk about Donovan McNabb and what he's been through this week, and certainly it's been talked about, argued about, digested by this point. The bottom line is Donovan McNabb could not have handled himself better as the leader of this Philadelphia Eagles organization, and he comes out of this situation looking so good with the team firmly behind him.
All I kept thinking all week was thank God it happened to him, because he could handle it.
On first down, this is Staley, right up the middle. And Deuce Staley gets it out to the 48.
You know, one of the weaknesses, I believe, for this Washington Redskins team, they let Darrell Gardner and Dan Wilkinson get out of here, Wilkinson with the contract dispute and everything that was going on. But the guys right up front, I just think there's an ability to run the ball right up at them. And if you want to take pressure off of Donovan McNabb, you want to get Donovan McNabb out of the so-called slump that he's in, allow this running game to get going a little bit. It has never been a big part of what Andy Reid believes. He's a West Coast guy, but in the NFL today, you have to do that.
22 seconds and counting in this first quarter, and McNabb airs it. And it's picked off. What a play by Smoot. What a beautiful interception by Fred Smoot. Well, and Fred Smoot has led this Redskins defense and interceptions the last couple of years, and the main reason for that is because teams do not want to challenge Champ Bailey, so he's going to get a lot of opportunities. Here he is on James Thrash. Donovan McNabb just is not able to quite get it out there. Fred Smoot in great position, just goes up and makes the play. What a great interception by Fred Smoot.
Well, it looked all the way like Thrash was in position to make the play, and Smoot just went up higher and wanted it a little bit more, and he does not lack for confidence, that young man. Now, you can say anything you want about him. Only weighs 168 pounds, but he's out there playing big.
This is Betts. He runs right up the middle on the Eagles. And that'll do it for the first quarter here in Philadelphia. Gorgeous day weather-wise, and so far the Eagles have all the points. Three on a 52-yarder by David Akers. Redskins come away with the interception. They have the ball as they trail by three. The NFL on Fox will continue after these messages.
Why do I rent from Enterprise? Because having the right car or truck makes all the difference. Sweetheart, your honey-do list just got a little bit longer. Sorry.
Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
A father's life will be undone.
He sent my daughter in there!
Critics are calling Mystic River the best movie so far this year.
Bury us in sin. We wash them clean.
Mystic River, rated R. Select cities October 8th, everywhere October 15th.
You're watching the NFL on Fox.
It silenced the skeptics. It defied the laws of physics. It tested the limits of human ingenuity. What will it do next? Introducing the new LS from Lexus.
With this computer, you can even edit and burn home movies on DVD.
That'll be great for the stuff we'll shoot on vacation.
Mm-hmm. Oh, where are you going? Rafting. Did I mention you can edit stuff out?
That'd be good.
Thousands of possibilities. Get yours. Best Buy.
From Ron Howard and Imagine Television.
Securities and Exchange Commission.
They have both?
Comes the fall's best new sitcom.
You love it here?
I'm having the time of my life.
Hey, T-Bone.
Arrested Development premieres Sunday, November 2nd on Fox.
3-0 Philadelphia after one. You look at these statistics, and I'm just going to say, Chris, my ego won't allow me to believe that I got booed by the entire crowd here when they flashed our picture up on the scoreboard. I think it's the guy in the middle here.
And they booed Santa Claus here, too. It's a compliment.
They were all over Aikman moments ago. Slipping and falling as Betts looked like he had a hole to use over that left side, and he ends up with only two. Third down and short coming up.
Boy, it didn't take many of these Jim Johnson blitzes to get Steve Spurrier back to his game plan. He came in here salivating a little bit over the fact that they had all these young kids in the secondary and thought he could throw it all over the park. All of a sudden, he got his quarterback hit in the back of the head a few times, and he said, you know, maybe this running game's not all bad after all.
Jim Johnson, the defensive coordinator on your left, and Steve Spurrier, the old ball coach on your right. Third down and two. Ramsey fires too high, and it's picked off. Roderick Hood. He's the nickelback with all the injuries in this secondary, and Ramsey has had men open, but he is missing badly, and that one had too much heat on it.
Well, that's just exactly right, Joe. He's got Lavernius Coles right here, and he just had too much on it, and then it was high.
I think all the hits he's been taking is shaking him up a little bit. I mean, this is not the Patrick Ramsey that we have seen. He's missed on a simple little rollout pass. He misses on a play that should have been a first down. I don't care who you are. If you're a quarterback and you're getting hit as much as he's been hit early, it has an impact, and he's been playing a pretty poor game so far.
On first down, McNabb hands it to Staley. He's down to the 11, gain of 7.
You know, Deuce Staley still working himself into shape, which we talked about it a little bit earlier, missed most of training camp, came in late. And that's one of the reasons why he has not gotten to play more than what he has this early in the year. Not that he's so much out of condition as much as he's just out of football shape.
Offensive line for the Eagles getting to do what it wants to do, and that is run block. Take it to this defense, and it's Staley. He ran into a wall, looked like just shy of first down yardage, a gain of only 2. It'll be third down coming up.
Talked a little bit about the Washington Redskins defensive line, and I think they're a little soft in here. Watch these guys plow the Redskins just directly off the ball. I mean, that's just taking them and moving them straight backwards. And in the NFL, short of Dallas Cowboys offensive line when Troy was playing, you just don't see that. Everybody positions blocks, but they are pushing them straight backwards now.
Well, John Runyon was so excited about the game plan last week. He said, you get tired of always absorbing the blow in pass protection. In run blocking, you know where the guy's going to be, and you get to go pound on him a little bit.
Third down and 1. Play action. McNabb fires, and the pass is caught. He has been busy. L.J. Smith. And it's a first down for Philadelphia.
Yeah, and that's the one area where Donovan McNabb really needs to improve upon. L.J. Smith out there all by himself in the flat, and Donovan not able to get the ball to him to where he can run after the catch. And you see that a lot. Donovan, of course, has never been a real accurate passer, but there are things that you can do in order to improve upon that. As we get down in here in the red zone, the Eagles have not scored a touchdown via the air this season. They've done it on the ground 3 times.
First and goal from the 6, and they stay on the ground. This is Buckhalter.
I just really appreciate what Andy Reid is trying to do in this ball game. You know, for whatever you want to say, and Donovan McNabb went through so much this week, and God bless him for all he had to go through. But Andy Reid, I thought, against Buffalo and now coming back in this one, is trying to stick to the running game. It is not what Philadelphia does best, but he is trying to get his quarterback comfortable. He's trying to protect him, not get him hit, and it's beginning to pay some dividends with this offense.
Second down and goal. Over the middle, pass is caught. Richie, touchdown. And the first touchdown pass of the season for McNabb.
Well, this really puts the defense in a bind. You're going to see Richie coming here to the on the crossing route. Linebacker overplays it, gives him the inside lane. Donovan puts it on his chest where he can protect himself. LeVar Arrington not able to get there in time, overplayed it, thinking that Richie was going to the flat. John Richie comes back underneath on the cross route.
That dates back to last season, including the playoffs. First touchdown throw and 173 pass attempts.
Yeah, ironically, the next closest active quarterback without a touchdown pass was Jeff Garcia, who also got one today.
On that extra point, a penalty flag comes in.
Jeff Garcia with 60, so it gives you some idea of how long it's been since McNabb had a touchdown pass. 173 attempts, that's amazing.
It's a hold against the Eagles.
By the kicking team, number 89. It's a 10-yard penalty retry.
On his 32nd birthday, it's Chan Lewis. go back to the touchdown, and it looked like Richie definitely got across into the end zone for his first touchdown as an Eagle.
So hard when you run those double crossing routes, the linebacker's forced to jump the first one, the second guy comes in there always with a great angle.
Akers drills it. So Richie is into the end zone, and Donovan McNabb has his first touchdown pass of the season. 10-0 Philadelphia.
Only one truck has crossbars that are welded through the side rails. That truck is the new Ford F-150. It has the strongest, toughest frame of any full-size pickup, which also gives you the highest payload. Only this truck earned the right to be the next F-150. If you haven't looked at Ford lately, look again.
Okay, two blades are better than one, and three blades are better than two. And that's as good as it gets, right? Wrong. The new Schick Quattro has the power of four blades and two conditioning strips, which makes Quattro unlike any other razor. And those four blades give you an incredibly close, smooth shave. So your 5 o'clock shadow shows up late. Four blades. Where will it stop? Here. Schick Quattro. The power of four.
Your boss expects a report in 1 hour. But it's a gorgeous 74 degrees outside. So, you handle it like a true professional. With a laptop powered by Centrino, Intel's mobile technology, you can work wirelessly in thousands of places, even Bryant Park, under your favorite tree. Intel Centrino mobile technology.
Fox NFL Sunday is brought to you by Sprint, proudly offering picture mail and PCS vision picture phones. By Capital One, what's in your wallet? By Intel Centrino mobile technology. And by Midas.
Well, Veterans Stadium has seen its last event, and the city of Philadelphia should be very proud of this brand new football stadium. It is absolutely gorgeous, with a new baseball park ready to be open next season for the Phillies. Just a five-play drive after the interception by Roderick Hood, and Akers will kick it back to the Redskins. Morton from the goal line. Brought down at the 22. 21-yard return. Patrick Ramsey back to work with his Redskins down by 10.
There are ordinary disposable razors, but now there's new Sensor 3 from Gillette. Totally new handle, three blades, on springs that adjust to your face. No disposable shaves better. It could be the best disposable you ever threw away. New Gillette Sensor 3.
I break for yard sales.
I break for little old ladies. Donuts.
Boys. UFOs.
I break for free oil changes.
Visit your local Midas mechanic now and get a free oil change with any Midas brake job. That's free oil and filter with any new brakes.
It is a Capital One, no hassle card, isn't it?
No. Cinderella's got my credit card!
Whether your card is lost or stolen, with a Capital One, no hassle card, you're not liable for a penny. With the nation's lowest fixed rates at 4.99 APR.
Hey! What's in your wallet?
It's almost threatening to initiate an outbreak of a very deadly virus.
To stop a weapon that has no cure.
They found a body that's been infected.
You need a man who knows no limits.
Just do it now!
The season premiere of 24, Tuesday, October 28th on Fox. Presented without commercial interruption by the next Ford F-150.
10 to nothing, Philadelphia on top, and things are going according to plan for the Philadelphia Eagles. Joe Bock, Troy Aikman, Chris Collinsworth with you, and Patrick Ramsey is back out there on the field, and so far not so good for his body. He's been knocked around.
Well, it's amazing when you start getting hit, don't even talk about sacks, but when you're getting hit and you're going to the ground as a quarterback, it definitely affects you and you start rushing a lot of throws, which is what happened on the interception.
That was no doubt the key play. The Hood interception. Now this one is fired to the tight end Royal. And Robert will lunge forward to the 29. Lito Shepard on the stop. And this is the key play. It was a third down throw. And Coles, who doesn't have a catch today, was open. The throw too high and too much. The interception, and it leads to the John Ritchie touchdown reception.
Would it be inappropriate for me to call down to Steve Spurrier on the sideline and say, come on. Come on, throw the ball down the field. What are you doing? It's like small ball. That's not Steve Spurrier.
I don't think it would be inappropriate at all.
I think it would be crossing the line. This will make you smile. Little double reverse and a first down as Coles can't get one through the air, but he gets one on a toss. They go left. They come back right, and Coles picks up a Washington first down.
You know, this is the biggest big play offense in football, and so far they've been playing small ball out there. They've been trying to dink it and dunk it and avoid the sacks and
I want them to throw it down the field.
You play action, you take a couple of shots down the field. You got to stretch the defense
The only problem with that is that Ramsey's back there getting hit and they don't want him holding the ball, and you have to do that in order to get the ball down the field. They're trying to get it out and protect him right now as best they can.
Yeah, but if you don't make this defense back off at some point, you're going to get hit all day.
Quick throw.
You can't do that all day. Stop it.
Sheldon Brown.
Stop it.
The intended receiver.
Now, I'm going to argue with this guy sitting right next to me now. A five-step drop, throw the thing deep against man coverage. You're not going to get hit. That's as safe a throw as you can get.
He's been getting hit all day, Chris. He's already been on his back.
I'm telling you, though, five-step drop, you hit your back foot, you can throw the ball down the field. But right now, these corners are sitting out there just squatting on these little pass plays.
I think the Bears are going to call you next week for an offensive coordinator.
Oh, man. Come on. Here comes another blitz.
And the handoff is to Kennedy. And Trunk Kennedy is tripped up, brought down a yard shy of a first down.
And really, when you look at that, Trunk Kennedy getting by that first line of defense, and defensive coordinators, when they start bringing pressure, they're very concerned that if it is a run, like it was there, and you get past those blitzers, there's nobody there to stop the running back. And that was a nice call by Steve Spurrier and a good execution.
It's third down at about a yard and a half. Off. That's Cartwright, and he falls forward for a first down.
Tell you what, that's a heck of a run by Cartwright. There really wasn't anything out there on the outside, and does just a nice little spin move to find a gap of some kind and get that first down. And I tell you, this Redskins offense desperately needed a first down. They had done absolutely nothing today. But watch a little spin move here at the end. That is the smallest of holes to try and find, and big play in the ball game.
Went away from Michael Lewis, who's getting the start at strong safety. First down. Here you go, Chris. Little pump fake in the air and out, and Coles is held. They can't find another yellow flag to throw on that. Everybody reached into their pocket. And Michael Lewis, who did not make the stop on that carry by Cartwright on third down, grabbed a hold of Cole's jersey.
Well, here's what's been going on. They're squatting on every single route. They're jumping. So now you go a little hook and go, throw it down the field.
Defense, number 32. The ball is placed at the spot of the foul. Automatic first down.
Now all of a sudden, as a defensive back, you're not quite so gutsy to come up and play those little dinky hitch routes and all that junk that I hate anyway.
Well, what was good about that was that the Eagles actually were running a two-deep coverage. They were playing pass coverage, and yet they were able to run the double move on the safety. Typically, those types of routes are run on corners. They got it on Michael Lewis and then got the interference.
And the key was an interference call, which takes the ball to the 35 instead of a defensive hold, which would have been only a 5-yard penalty. Here's a 5-yard penalty.
False start, offense, number 76. 5-yard penalty, it's still first down.
And that's on John Jansen, and between him and Chris Samuels, they've had a number of these kinds of penalties. They had several last week, and now they're starting off the game here, but that's been a real frustration for Steve Spurrier and some of these illegal procedure movements that they've had.
And Troy, one of the problems that happened there is Ramsey has not been communicating those checks to the backs. It's the reason he's been getting hit. So I think when he turned around, it threw Jansen off.
Here they are.
Here we go again. See, he's going to tell the backs, because the backs don't know what's going on.
It's a toss to candidate. He loses yardage. Loss of two.
Well, sometimes you start out smarting yourself a little bit as an offensive coach, and if you want to start getting to a check-in game at the line of scrimmage, you're going to lose that with Jim Johnson. Right here, they try checking to the toss sweep. Corey Simon, number 90, who's having an outstanding season up to this point in pursuit right there, is able to get over there and help turn it back inside. And Corey Simon is just having a very good year last week. He opens up the game with a sack. He's done a great job of pushing the middle of that pile from the inside defensive tackle position.
Ramsey notices that the play clock is about to expire. And so far, this is a team that can't play with crowd noise. That's bad when you're on the road in the NFL.
Come on in, Derek. Derek, I thought we had this thing worked out. I hear you're out dancing, eating, and just carousing with your friends. Is it true you're going out every night?
Absolutely not.
Good.
If you want to enjoy the New York nightlife, bring your Visa card, because Orso, Cheetah, and the Broom Street Bar don't take American Express. Visa, it's everywhere you want to be.
Hey, Derek, we are running late. Sorry.
3 minutes to go in the period. Third down. The ball is at the 4-yard line.
Here's my man. Come on.
All right, showtime.
Pepsi and Lay's, official sponsors of the NFL.
We engineered a material behind the dash called Quiet Steel. Only the new Ford F-150 has it, which means it's the only truck to deliver this. The sound of quality. The sound of the quietest pickup, period. Only this truck earned the right to be the next F-150. If you haven't looked at Ford lately, look again.
Fox NFL Sunday is brought to you by the next Ford F-150, built Ford tough.
Little chill in the air. It's October in Philadelphia, and this Redskin offense is going backward. I talked about them struggling with crowd noise. They had 3 false start penalties last week at home, let alone being in this new stadium where they say at times it can be louder than the vet.
You got to be real careful when you get to the line of scrimmage and you start trying to audible and getting out of plays when you're on the road in a hostile crowd like this one.
Ramsey's changing it up again.
That's that.
Ramsey fires, has Coles, and no catch. Juggled and dropped out of bounds. Roderick Hood already has an interception, and he was right there step for step with Coles.
Yeah, that's a good point, Joe, because what we're seeing right now is that these young defensive backs, many of whom I never even heard of coming in here, Clinton Hart and some of these guys that Roderick Hood, they are just eating up these so-called great receivers for the Washington Redskins. And that's their $13 million guy. They can't get away from a guy that was a walk-on in college.
Now just trying to get into field goal range, you would think, and penalty flags before the snap.
Well, so far, Michael Lewis looks like a genius on that.
Before the ball was snapped, ball start. Offense, number 66. 5-yard penalty, still third down.
That's Dockery, who's playing in place of the injured Dave Fiore.
The holding on Michael Lewis that saved a touchdown looks like may not even end up now with a field goal out of the Washington Redskins. They are just really struggling, Troy, with this snap count stuff. It killed them last week, and it's killing them again.
They practiced this week using a silent count. On third and 22. Pass is too high again, and Ramsey is no doubt flustered and out of sync. This start here today in Philadelphia, whether it's the hits or now everybody in the league is talking about him, they're off to a great start. How great is Patrick Ramsey? And not too good today.
No, well, not up to this point, but the one thing he has been able to do is he's rebounded. You know, he usually has put together at least one good half in each of the games that he's played. And
so he's due?
He's due in the second half, yeah.
Beautiful punt by Barker. Westbrook lets it go over his head, and it's so beautiful it rolls into the end zone. 47-yard punt. But these Eagles so far are smiling, laughing, having fun. Up by 10 on the old ball coach. Just a grimace.
With capabilities that will amaze you, both on-road and off, Ford Explorer is the most trusted SUV in America.
Hey, honey.
Sorry I'm late. We took a wrong turn at Greenland.
If you haven't looked at Ford lately, look again.
In my dream, I'm on a game show.
Welcome back to On Demand, where it's time for round two. And the question is, the efficiency of 342 cases of green Argyle socks. Correct. Your customers...
2,000 SKUs.
You don't know the answers?
It's like they know what's coming.
Where? Maple Avenue.
What does it mean?
You're playing catch-up because you're not responsive. You need your answers faster.
George Clooney.
My God. Look at her.
Catherine Zeta-Jones.
What are you off to, Miles?
You? This Friday, watch the sparks fly.
Is that all?
No, that's not all. Intolerable Cruelty, rated PG-13, starts Friday.
Philly Cheesesteak Pizza.
No drooling this time.
Guys like Philly Cheesesteak, guys like Domino's Pizza. That's why Domino's created the new Philly Cheesesteak Pizza. Get a medium for only $9.99 and any second medium for just $5 more. Get the door. It's Domino's new Philly Cheesesteak Pizza.
Sunday, November 2nd, the fear will be here. It's the most terrifying chase with death you've ever seen. All new Simpsons Treehouse of Horror, Sunday, November 2nd on Fox.
10-0, the Eagles out in front. They get the ball back, starting at their own 20. A rattled Patrick Ramsey takes a seat. And it's this Washington defense, ranked 15th in the NFL, trying to get something turned around the Redskins' way. Hand off this to Staley. Gain of 3. In case you missed our pregame show today, here's what you missed.
Emmitt's always been one of my favorites. Today, he will be hit, I promise you.
If you hadn't ran him so damn much, you might still be in Dallas. You rode him like Angel Cordero.
You may have to end up taking Kurt and go back to the Arena League and then... Hello?
I'll tell you what, the whole NFL needed a good laugh this week, didn't we? Guys delivered today.
McNabb flips, and it's out of the reach of L.J. Smith. And in case you missed some of the early games and the early game headliners, Quincy Carter, man, what's going on there?
I tell you what, they've got him focused in on what they're trying to do offensively. And between Bill Parcells and then the offensive coordinator slash assistant head coach Sean Payton have just done a tremendous job of giving him some confidence. Of course, they got a pretty good receiving core they've been throwing the ball to.
What about Randy Moss? 5 touchdowns down in the last 2 weeks.
Should be smiling in that picture. He's had a great run.
I took the picture.
Third down and 8. McNabb throws it, and it's picked
up.
What a play by Trotter. And the former Eagle is out of bounds at the one.
You know, Joe, this is one of the things, Donovan McNabb, if you look back to last week and some of the previous games just this year, when he's had people close to the line of scrimmage that he's trying to get the ball to, he throws a pretty flat ball, and there have been opportunities for these defenders to come down with interceptions. This time they get one.
Trotter just read it all the way, and you're talking about a guy with a comeback year, not only injured last year, but really it was just a disastrous year after coming over from Philadelphia. He wasn't used to this style of system, the one-gap system. He made a lot of mistakes. He got blown out every time they played Philadelphia. He was embarrassed on multiple occasions, especially playing against this team. To come back and make that kind of a play here would mean a lot.
You, there's wide receivers that don't make catches like that.
It was McNabb on the tackle, and it's Ramsey on the quarterback keeper, and no signal.
Well, that ought to feel good on that sore left shoulder.
Looked like he didn't get the snap because he was sort of slow crawling out of there and trying to get over the top.
Yeah, I saw the same thing. It looked like the snap was fumbled a little bit.
It's dangerous as a quarterback when you try and get that snap and pull it and get the ball up over the top. Sometimes you hit the center's bottom on the way up.
Yeah, what they'll tell the quarterback oftentimes is just to take a step back and let the line fire off before you go forward. He was slow getting out of there.
This is Betts. And Liddell Betts.
Uh-oh.
Now it's third down and goal.
Now we're down to that uh-oh play. All of a sudden you're down there on the one-inch line and you're having trouble getting it in. This is kind of the way the day's gone for the Washington Redskins so far.
Well, the Philadelphia Eagle defensive front just gets lower and looks like Betts had a line there that he could have gotten in, but Sheldon Brown and company there to stop him.
Bryan Johnson, the fullback, got stuffed.
Ramsey with a touchdown. He got it that time up over the top. And the Redskins are into the end zone.
Boy, this thing went from being a game that looked like it was just going to be a nice little cakewalk for the Philadelphia Eagles. All of a sudden, one big play, and we've got ourselves a ball game. This is typical Washington Redskins football so far this year, though.
Yeah, this is the way that it's been. All of the games that they've played have been decided by 3 points or less.
Might have a challenge.
Well, he clearly got into the end zone.
I agree.
On that replay.
You know, that first interception that Donovan had, the Redskins weren't able to capitalize. They come back and turn it back over, but on this one they're able to, and here's another look.
Philadelphia is challenging the ruling on the field that the ball broke the plane of the goal line.
That's not really the definitive look. It looked like the replay before that one.
And this is going to be close. He starts with the ball extended out to where it looks like he's going to make it without any problem, but then he pulls it in right at the last minute.
Touchdown.
He's clearly over the plane.
Remember now, you don't have to cross the goal line. You only have to be on the front end of it. Once you cross any part of that white line, if the tip gets over any part of that white line, it's a touchdown, and I don't think there's any question. Certainly not enough evidence to overturn it. Right here, right on the front edge is all you have to get. Does not have to cross all the way to the back edge of the line.
Well, they even show the replay here on the board, and the crowd can't even react to it because he is definitely across the plane.
That sort of that little tuck almost cost him, though, didn't it?
Yeah, and I think he's doing it trying to protect it, but if the ball goes across with your arm extended, it's a touchdown at that point, even if the ball gets knocked out. So,
and even if you pulled it back over the other way.
Correct.
Again, they show it on the replay board here, and you can bet if there was any uncertainty about it, this crowd would have been going crazy. But Ed Hockley was going to do curls, I think, and bench press during halftime with those pipes of his. Will come back on and give us the call.
The ball broke the plane of the goal line, therefore the ruling on the field stands. Touchdown. Philadelphia is charged with a timeout.
So there you go. It's 10-6 and the extra point coming from Hall. And it's the defense and the former Eagle who left here. $36 million later, he's a Washington Redskin. Did not get along with Andy Reid right at the end. They let him walk. He ends up in Washington, and the big middle linebacker makes a play.
You know, last week in the game against New England, it was the Redskins defense that came up with a big play to get him back in that one as well. So maybe this will wake up this offense, because they have been terrible so far today.
Ball for the point after, and it's a three-point game. So the interception by Donovan McNabb leads to 7 points. Well, it has really been a tournament-type feel for the baseball playoffs this October, and tonight, Kerry Wood will take on the Atlanta Braves and Mike Hampton down at Turner Field in Atlanta, and that game is all yours tonight right here on Fox. 7:30 Eastern, 4:30 Pacific. Game 5, the winner moves on to take on the Florida Marlins.
And I know baseball purists hate those 5-game series, but from a fan standpoint, every pitch is important. It's every one of those games are just so intense. Sometimes you get in the championship series in games 1 and 2, you're kind of jockeying for position almost. Those 5-game series, man, it's a fist fight from the beginning.
Yeah, I think that's fair. That's a good point. But I do think that there are enough people now around baseball, and enough cities and good teams have been burned in a 5-game series, that will be discussed this upcoming offseason to try to extend that first round of the division playoffs. And if you do that, you may have to cut back a little bit during the regular season. Otherwise, you're playing baseball into November.
Well, you want ridiculous. The best teams. Obviously, you want the best teams advancing. As someone watching baseball, you would think you would. And anytime you shorten a series, then it gives some of these lesser teams an opportunity.
Saw that Yankee score. They're trying to move on to the ALCS again. Knocked out last year in the first round by the Angels. This is Morey. Crosses the 25, and they will mark him down just shy of the 27. Let's go back for a game break. Los Angeles and JB.
And Joe, Steve Mariucci hoping his troops can make more of a game of a trailing 17-3. Jody Harrington hooks up with a big tight end. Michael Ricks, 6-yard strike. It is now a 17-10 ball game. San Francisco on top of Detroit. Back to Joe, Troy, Chris, and Pam.
Boy, Mariucci's really made a difference in Detroit. It hasn't quite translated into wins yet, but you could just see it coming, can't you, Troy? I mean, they are getting better.
Well, it's been a great thing for Joey Harrington. You can see his development each and every week.
On first down, McNabb buys a little time and finds a wide open Mitchell. And Freddie Mitchell stays on his feet. Great run after the catch by the former number one pick. They took Freddie Mitchell in the first round out of UCLA back in 2001. He's played 35 games now, including this one, as a total of 1 touchdown.
And again, from that Redskins defensive front four, when they are only rushing 4, getting no pressure whatsoever, the Freddie Mitchell showing what most people have said he doesn't have, and that's guts and courage and fight, and he stayed with that play and did a little thing at the end of it. And I don't think the Redskins could believe he escaped.
38-yard play in the end. And from the 35, it's Westbrook. Brian Westbrook, a first down at the 21.
And that's what Brian Westbrook has been showing through these first few ball games. He was hurt early in the preseason, missed the last 3 games. But he's come back and he's got a real burst. Of course, this offensive line, John Ritchie leading the way up in there, and he's got a burst that gets him to that second level faster than any of the other backs that they have. Just great execution by that offensive line up front.
And I tell you what, Bobby Williams, who came in for Jermaine Mayberry, made a great block on that one.
On first down, Staley. Deuce Staley to the 18 and a few inches beyond, a gain of 3.
You know, and that's the thing that I don't quite understand. When you got Brian Westbrook, of course, he's coming back out on the field right now, but when you have a run like that, and then all of a sudden they're changing running backs and bringing in Deuce Staley, I'd have to believe that that throws your momentum off a little bit and a little bit of the confidence that you've got established up front, and keep those guys in there as long as they're running well.
It's almost like they don't want to offend the other running backs. To me, clearly Westbrook has been the guy.
Second down and 7. McNabb in trouble. Brought down from behind, Bruce Smith.
196 and a half career sacks. Reggie White, the all-time leader with 198. And this was more of a coverage sack than anything else. Donovan McNabb had time to throw the football and just was unable to find anybody. James Thrash looked like he had a step on his man, and Todd Pinkston there, of course, he was getting some safety help. But when Donovan drops back and he realizes that he doesn't have anywhere to go, especially down here in the red zone, that's when you've got to be willing to unload it.
We're getting close to history for Bruce Smith. Now it just needs two to break Reggie White's all-time record.
Third down and 11. Quick throw, Pinkston. First down at the five. Donovan McNabb was working on this route in the pregame warm-ups. They're going to run a slant. He starts Champ outside, and once Champ starts outside and gets back on his heels, it opens up the throwing lane for Donovan to fire the ball in there. And talking with Brad Childress, the offensive coordinator yesterday for the Eagles, he said that's one of the things that Donovan feels most comfortable when he's able to see where he's throwing the ball to the outside. He unloads it with confidence.
Movement along the line of scrimmage prior to the snap.
Before the ball was snapped, ball start. Offense number 72, 5-yard penalty, still first down.
You know, anytime you see a defensive back like Champ Bailey that time moving back to the outside, you know he's expecting some kind of help to the inside. That was not a straight man-to-man coverage. When you get man-to-man coverage, especially bump and run, they're going to try and take away the slant. So I don't know exactly if the safety didn't get there or there was a miscommunication, but he had to be expecting some help with that kind of a release all
the time. Yeah, I think he's expecting some help from the linebacker, and maybe the splits had him thinking that Pinkston was going to try to run a go route. McNabb brought down behind the line of scrimmage by Ojalete. Loss of two.
Redskins throwing a little blitz back at the Philadelphia Eagles. A little good measure in return there. They brought about seven on this one. Can't tell if it was a design draw. I think it was. Well, I don't know. He was trying to step up. There just was nowhere to go with that one.
Yeah, Ifeanyi Ojalete, he's the guy who comes in and is able to finally get McNabb to the ground. And he was a backup a year ago, and they didn't think that he was going to be the starter. Of course, he beat out David Terrell, who had been the two-year starter at that position, but he just had an outstanding preseason. He's been starting all this season.
Second down and goal when we come back. Two-minute warning in Philadelphia.
Fox NFL Sunday is brought to you by Wachovia. Together we can achieve uncommon things.
What can glass teach us about corporate and investment banking? Success requires both strength and imagination. At Wachovia Securities, we learn from the world around us. Because uncommon challenges call for uncommon wisdom. Wachovia Securities, corporate and investment banking.
Didn't just give the new Ford F-150 more horsepower. We gave it the most low-end torque. Why did we push farther than anyone else? So you could do more than anyone else. Only this truck earned the right to be the next F-150. If you haven't looked at Ford lately, look again.
Coming up on the Visa Halftime Report, J.B., Terry, Howie, and Jimmy will have scores and highlights from around the league. Come on, everybody together. You've been watching this all day. And the new and improved Fox Sports ticker has up to the second scores and stats. Attaway. They're waiting for this first half to finish. There are 2 minutes remaining.
That hat has been in the family for a long time.
Oh, yeah.
Grandpa wore that one about 50 years ago.
Second down and goal.
Or Jaworski won.
Ball from just outside the 12. Wide open and now dropped. They're going to say incomplete. Westbrook never had it. Boy, he took a smack.
That was Trotter again. Trotter stepping up and playing a monster game here against his old team.
Spurrier is hoping that the booth will review it. And it was Trotter.
You know, the Redskins got burned on one of these last week that they thought should have been a completion to Lavernius Coles. He had the ball, but they are just going to be so quick to call that one incomplete. Really no reason to even challenge it.
Third down and goal. McNabb rolls right, throws left, and Staley.
They're calling that a fumble.
And that a lateral.
Yeah, and they're going to mark it right back there. No whistle blew.
Staley ends up picking it up, and that's at least a break for the Eagles that he didn't give up on the play and walk off in disgust.
That was smart on Deuce Staley's part, and you see Donovan McNabb's reaction to it, and he knew that he made a poor throw on the play, and if he's able to get the ball up higher where Deuce Staley's able to catch it, he might have been able to make a play out of it. Heads up play, though, by Deuce Staley. 36-yard drive from Akers. And no surprise, David Akers, one of, if not the best in the business. Now 94 field goals, the most ever in Eagles history. Patrick Ramsey will head back to work, and after the juggling act last year, heck, you can go back to since 1993, and since Mark Rippon left, Gannon, Kerry Conklin, Freeze, Shuler, Ferrat, Hostetler, Trent Green, Brad Johnson, Jeff George, Tony Banks, Matthews, Werfel, and now Ramsey. And I think there's a tendency to look back and think to his rookie season last year and how much further along he would have been had he have played more, but it's hard to argue with the results. I mean, he got some playing time last year. He's come into this season, has played exceptionally well for the most part. And I really like this guy. He's a tough guy, as we've talked about, but he can make so many throws that you watch veteran quarterbacks that they can't even execute. And I think you're right. I think the Redskins have found their quarterback for the future. He's going to be playing for a long time.
Yeah, he's getting another lesson, though, from Jim Johnson out here today, because this team, the Redskins as a group, are going to have to be able to play against the blitz, because it is the MO. Anytime you have a young quarterback and this style of offense where you want to get your backs out into the pass routes and not protect, your quarterback is going to have to make some quick reads, get the ball out of there, don't take the sacks, don't have the big negative plays. It's a lot to ask from a young quarterback.
And it's really against the nature of your guy Spurrier to pull it back and go into a shell and keep backs in to help protect. As Akers kicks it away, Chad Morton on the return from inside the five. Morton has blocking in front of him. Good return out across the 30. They'll mark him down at the 33, a 29-yard return. And with two timeouts remaining and 59 seconds on the clock, it's the two-minute offense for the Washington Redskins and young Patrick Ramsey.
You know, I was talking to Jim Johnson the other day and asking him, Steve Spurrier and his system, is there anything that Steve Spurrier does from a system standpoint that you don't see each and every week in this league? And he said, no. We've seen it before, but he says Steve Spurrier does as good a job as anybody anticipating what the defensive calls will be.
There's the first catch of the day by Lavernius Coles, and he has a lane down the sideline, cuts back inside the 40.
I tell you what, if you're going to go that far with a quick screen, some offensive lineman is going to have to knock somebody out. And Derek Dockery turned the corner. He's the guy playing for Dave Fiore today and just rush somebody down the field.
31 seconds and counting left. Pass complete to candidate. Stays on his feet, gets to the 30. And the Redskins will burn a timeout.
And Troy, one of the difficult parts about having a young secondary out there is it's very difficult to call those blitzes on the fly now. So now in this hurry-up offense, which may be a formula for Spurrier in the second half, force those young guys back there to make some quick decisions. If they want to try and blitz, make them do it on the fly instead of coming out of the huddle.
Yeah, and Jim Johnson's trying to do everything that he can to mix things up. He knows that if Steve Spurrier is able to get a bead on what he's calling back there in that secondary, that he's going to be in for a long afternoon. And so they're trying to mix it up as best they can. They've mixed in some zone. They've mixed in some man-to-man coverages. And for the most part, this Eagles defense has done a very good job.
I'll tell you what, I think I would go screen, draw, maybe a quick trap, something here, because now coming out of the huddle, my guess is blitz out of Philadelphia.
Redskins already in field goal range. Airing it out, Ramsey, and the pass is broken up. Rock Cartwright, the intended receiver, and Clinton Hart got over and made a play.
You know, when you play against Jim Johnson, you're going to get a blitz generally to the left, to the right, or right up the middle. They don't typically bring the all-out blitzes and play man coverage without safety help. So you're going to have to read it on the fly. That time they're going to try and come down this side, and then they'll drop back on this side. And yet Ramsey just threw right back into it because he really didn't have anything on the other side. But you've got to read it on the fly.
It's great range there by Clinton Hart, being able to get over the top and make a play on that ball. Timeout has been called for by Philadelphia. We're going to take a look at Clinton Hart coming over, and if Ramsey had been able to lay a little air on that when Rock Cartwright was going to run by Clinton Hart, they may have had a shot, but Patrick Ramsey did not see Clinton Hart coming over the top.
The other blitz that we haven't seen so far that I really expected to see in this ball game is that one right up the gut. They ran it a lot against Buffalo last week. They were practicing it a lot this week. And anytime you end up in a situation where you can bring that pressure right up the gut, right up the middle, especially with some of the young guys, Derek Dockery in there playing in that offensive line, might be able to take advantage.
One of the concerns if you're the Washington Redskins right now is if you drop back with a deep set, you may drop back out of field goal range. And with the way the Ramsey's been under pressure all day, it may not be worth it. Third down and three. They back out of the blitz, and Ramsey fires it. It is broken up. Gardner was the one who made the play on Sheldon Brown, who had better position for the reception.
Well, he really did. Sheldon Brown was in perfect position to come down with the ball, and Rod Gardner does a nice job of just keeping it from being intercepted. And Ramsey, under a little bit of pressure in the pocket, just throws it up, trying to give his guy an opportunity. He just wasn't able to get it up high enough for Rod Gardner, but a nice job breaking that ball up. Sheldon Brown could have very easily come down with that interception.
You know, but they're doubling up with that safety, so it looks like man coverage on the outside, but Ramsey better be careful because Michael Lewis could have gotten that one too.
Hall has missed four of his last nine attempts. A try from 48. A line drive kick that knuckles through to make it a three-point game.
Like one of my T-balls.
Oh, that was ugly.
Maybe sliced hard to the right, but perfectly through the goalpost. I thought he yanked it dead left when he first hit it, and it just sliced right back through. Played to win, maybe, huh? They say there's some strange winds that come out of here because it's a there's openings on three sides. Talking with David Akers, he said there really are some strange winds that happen in this stadium.
Spooky. That's the end zone there that they say they have the most problems because of the open ends. This other end zone where that one was just kicked, it's a little bit more closed in, so you don't get quite as much wind blowing through.
You were paying attention to it, Troy, before the game. Akers was spending a lot more time attempting field goals down to our left, down to the spot where there are two openings. Or he told you it's more difficult to figure out that swirling wind.
It is, and the strange thing is you see the flag there. It doesn't look like there's much wind blowing, but I made that comment to David Akers, and he says that's not accurate. He says there's actually a lot. It's a swirling effect.
And now the old squib kick. Picked up by Westbrook. And with that, the first half comes to a close. So the Redskins were able to get down the field, get into field goal range, and it was John Hall who hit from 48. It makes it a 13-10 game at the half. The Eagles looking for their first win here in their new home. The Visa Halftime Report coming up after this from your local Fox station.
There's a reason why October is sports greatest month. Chipper Jones' two home runs, the Braves stayed alive, forcing a decisive Game 5.
This thing is absolutely wild!
Now, Kerry Wood takes the mound, looking to make history and lead the Cubs to the NLCS. Game 5, tonight on Fox.
Starting with me, everything in this place is mean and miserable.
Is that a tear in your eye, Private? Do you want your mommy? Are you going to cry?
I'll kick the tradition and chivalry out of you.
I suggest you shut your mouth.
I can't hear you.
Nothing is over until we decide it is.
Just one more thing. Don't ever make me mad.
Sweet dreams, ladies. Straight left, right now. Ha!
Small businesses are good at focusing on what they're great at doing. Now there's high-speed internet that's just as focused. Introducing SBC Yahoo DSL Business Edition. Tools that match the way you work, content that's focused on what you do. Just $29.95 a month, guaranteed. Seeing small business differently. SBC.
Hey, you got that ordinary untoasted sub instead of the toasted Philly cheesesteak from Quiznos? What, were you raised by wolves?
Yes, I was.
Why have an ordinary sub? Try a delicious Quiznos toasted Philly cheesesteak or our other toasted sandwiches starting at $1.99.
Toasty.
To lock the car again.
Sorry.
The 469 horsepower E55 AMG. Feel the power of a Mercedes.
The Rockets liftoff with Jeff Van Gundy, Sunday on Sports Extra.
The Visa Halftime Report is brought to you by Visa. If you love the NFL, it's everywhere you...
Be watching Washington and Philadelphia. The Philadelphia Eagles were out to a 10-0 lead. Washington has come back to make it 13-10.
All right, Donovan McNabb, come on back. Let's have us a good ball game. Hosting the Redskins. Division rival back. Quick slant. There it is. Look at that. John Ritchie comes inside man coverage. Corner stayed outside. 4-yard touchdown. First touchdown pass on the season for McMahon. Then this pass for Freddie Mitchell. But Jeremiah Trotta is there. He picks it off. Leto Ramsey, quarterback sneak. Got a good ball game, 13-10 at the half, Philadelphia over Washington. Mariucci, welcome back in San Francisco. All of the 49ers loving and hugging on him, but not this guy. Terrell Owens, 6-yard touchdown reception from Jeff Garcia, makes it 7-0 49ers. And then Garcia, second touchdown pass on the day. This one, a 14-yarder, nice job by Aaron Walker, and it's 17-10. Detroit hanging in there pretty good. 49ers.
Byron Leftwich at the helm for the Jaguars, nursing a three-point lead over the Chargers. Green Bay all over the Seahawks, 35-13. First loss of the season for the Seahawks. Minnesota over the Atlanta Falcons. Vikings improving to 5-0. Well, I tell you what, Randy Moss and Mo Williams did a nice job there. Cowboys moved to 3-1 with that victory over Arizona. Not a good homecoming for Emmitt Smith. And the Panthers 4-0 for the first time in franchise history. Kansas City Chiefs 5-0 for the first time in franchise history there. Dante Hall with yet another return for a touchdown. The Bears, first victory of the season. That over Howie's Raiders. Not a pleasant Howie right now. And the Dolphins make it 3 straight. This time they beat the Giants. The Giants are 3-12 after a bye week. Bill Belichick, nice job of coaching as they beat the Titans 38-30. And the Bengals played a valiant ball game, but it was Buffalo coming through in the end 22-16. And Howie Long's Red Sox bounce back from a 4-3 deficit in the bottom of the eighth. Two-run double by David Ortiz. It is now going to be a Game 5 tomorrow on Fox. And if this score holds up, the Yankees, 6 runs in the fourth inning. If that score holds up, Game 5 between Boston and Oakland will be at 8 o'clock tomorrow night right here on Fox. Protection problems for the Redskins?
Yeah, and they need to be able to protect because they can get the ball down the field. Chris Collinsworth was exactly right when he was talking about the defensive backs for Philadelphia are setting on all the underneath routes, and you can beat them if you can get a double move and get it deep down the field, but you have to be able to protect because it takes longer to throw that pass.
Doesn't hurt you to say Chris was right, though.
Chris was exactly right. And those receivers, they always know when they're setting on
and Jim Johnson has done a nice job. They're calling this defense the Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid defense.
Why?
Who are those guys?
Oh, you two, boy.
You know,
these two. Anyway, some of you will be going to local news. Others will come back to see if the blonde bomber has got his act together.
I have taken him out.
Visa, if you love the NFL, it's everywhere you want to be. Monday, October 20th, Fox will introduce a real American cowboy to a group of European women.
Oh, he's good looking.
Tell them he's worth $80 million in oil.
I'm sure I'm gonna like this lifestyle.
And invite them to win his heart.
He's rich.
He's very rich.
Does anyone know how to say sucker in French? The next Joe Millionaire. Diplomats are standing by. Premieres Monday, October 20th on Fox. It's the home of beer, football, cheese, and now, Wednesday night comedy. This fall, Wisconsin is where the laughs live.
You're allergic to eggs.
Hey, pretty lady. You like what you see?
That 70s Show and A Minute with Stan Hooper.
Look, it's your head made out of cheese.
Holy Lord.
Wednesday nights, come for the laughs, stay for the cheese.
Damn it, Hooper, you're shredding us like mozzarella.
It all begins Wednesday, October 29th on Fox.
Boys and girls, can anyone spell this?
This is Deuce Staley of the Philadelphia Eagles.
C-A-T.
Deuce helps the United Way build stronger communities by supporting local educational programs.
Deuce, can you spell chrysanthemum?
Chrysanthemum? She got cat.
Does someone here need a timeout?
Chrysanthemum. C-H-R-Y-S-A-N-T-H-E-M-U-M. Chrysanthemum.
This is a Fox 26 News Break.
Hello, I'm Ford Atkinson.
And I'm Rashonda Tate. A quick news update right now from Fox 26. Tonight, Houston police are investigating the murder of a man in southeast Houston. 26-year-old Latrell Wembley was found dead late Saturday night. He'd been shot multiple times. Meanwhile, the victim's car has turned up missing. It's a dark green Pontiac Grand Prix with Texas license plate YBZ72L. Call Crime Stoppers if you spotted that car. That number, 713-222-TIPS.
A Houston community activist says she backed out of a mayoral ballot scheme. Community activist Brenda Flores says she gave a man with the same name as candidate Bill White $1,200 after he signed candidacy papers to run for mayor. She claims she received the money to carry out the scheme from a consultant associated with the campaign of mayoral candidate Sylvester Turner. Turner's camp denies the charges. Motorists in the eastern Texas panhandle are being told to slow down.
The Donnelly County Sheriff says drivers are in more danger than ever of colliding with a wild animal. Sheriff Butch Blackburn says the county has seen more deer killed by bumpers than by bullets. Texas parks and wildlife officials blame rising deer population.
Mike Pass joins us now with a quick check on the forecast. Mike?
Well, Ford, Rashonda, the showers and thunderstorms stayed away from Houston today, and they're still away, but they are going on from Shreveport down toward Dallas and then down into the middle of Texas, some very strong storms near Waco. These are moving eastward and may clip the northern edge of southeast Texas up in our northern viewing areas, but it doesn't look like Houston will get them this afternoon. But tonight is another story, and into Monday we have a chance of showers and thunderstorms. I'll put that chance at 20% for tonight and with the low in the upper 60s, and then 40% for tomorrow. And, of course, I'll have a complete update after baseball.
Well, that's the news for now. Join us for those stories and more after tonight's National League playoff game between Atlanta and Chicago on Fox 26 News. Then Fox Sports Extra will recap all of today's sports.
This has been a Fox 26 News Break.
Ford is the best in Texas.
And the proof is in the power. Ford F-150, with more available torque and payload than Chevy, Dodge, or Toyota. Ford Super Duty, with more pulling power than any other pickup on earth. And the Texas Auto Writers Association, voting Ford the truck line of Texas. Now get financing as low as 0% for 72 months or up to $4,000 cash back at your Texas Ford dealer.
I'm here in the Northwest to promote my Northwest chicken salad. It's really authentic with all the flavors of the Northwest, like authentic Northwest fajita-style chicken, roasted sweet corn, black beans, and the Northwest kick of spicy pepper jack cheese and creamy Northwest dressing. Wait a minute, that can't be right.
Whoops.
I'm here in the Southwest to promote my Southwest chicken salad.
Try the Southwest chicken salad, one of three salads made fresh daily.
A feast for your eyes, your soul, and your right foot. Presenting the 245 horsepower V6 Nissan Altima.
Here come the ducks!
Hello!
Here come the ducks! Ready?
The court declares the defendant pitiful. Absolutely pitiful.
We're talking model justice now.
I ain't saying
close your mouth!
Defense runs!
Something was going on in that house.
I don't
want to
see that.
It's just a day now. Here come the ducks. Here come the ducks.
Court is in session. Weekdays on Fox 26.
The Rockets liftoff with Jeff Van Gundy. Sunday on Sports Extra.
Third and 15. Maddox looking downfield as well as looking real classy in that authentic heavyweight nylon mesh jersey. He spots Burroughs, who makes an amazing fashion statement in a jersey that's rugged yet tasteful, tough yet trendy. That's a grass stain. Warm water and tumble dry low. That's a nice game ball, too.
Get whatever's on the field by calling 877-NFL-SHOP. For a free team catalog of NFL gear, call now or visit NFLShop on NFL.com.
Cowher's got to be happy with that stylish hat polo shirt combo.
13-10, Philadelphia on top, a late field goal by the Redskins. Make it a three-point game from William Penn to Joe, Troy, and Chris. And any surprises, anything jump out at you? Any recollections from the first half? Do you remember what went on so far today?
Sure. I think the Redskins are lucky to be in this game. They really have done very little offensively. The one play by Trotter gave them a cheap touchdown, but other than that, Philadelphia's defense has just dominated.
Well, they have. Philadelphia has completely outplayed this Redskin team, and if it weren't for the turnovers, it would be a much larger deficit than what the Redskins have now.
But as it is, it's only three.
That's it.
And we have a close game, finally.
Finally, we have a close game.
We like close games.
We do.
It's good.
Andy Reid stomping the sidelines, hoping that today is the day that the Eagles get a win in their new park. Two straight NFC East titles for Reid, and two times to the NFC Championship game. Only to come a few points shy of going to the Super Bowl. At St. Louis and at home against Tampa Bay last year. Second half begins, and the Eagles take the kickoff, and it's Westbrook. A little stutter step and a good return. After the 37, let's go down to the sideline and check in with Pam Oliver.
All right, Joe, talk to Andy Reid at halftime. He said obviously a little dissatisfied with the offensive missed opportunities there. He said it's just a matter of execution, but he also said we can't give them anything. Defensively, he's pretty pleased with the job that his group is doing. Meanwhile, for the Redskins, I asked Steve Spurrier, hey, what happened to all that wide open passing you alluded to? He says, well, maybe it's my play calling. I have to do a better job in the second half. Back to you.
All right, Pam, thanks.
Pam gets right to the point, doesn't she?
She's not scared to ask the question. Passes right through the hands of L.J. Smith. That thing was a rocket right there. And L.J. Smith, we sat down with Donovan McNabb. He even brought up the name Shockey. He said with what Shockey's done for the Giants, they believe in time L.J. Smith will be able to do for the Eagles.
And you saw what they had there. They had him flanked out to the side. They really like him flanked out, running some slants, running some double moves.
Second down and 10. Westbrook to the 39, gain of 3. I think you look back at last week and what Andy Reid did from a play calling standpoint, taking some of that pressure off of Donovan McNabb. He's doing the same thing here today because that's really not his style. I mean, he would very much like to just drop back and throw it each and every down, but he knows that he's had a quarterback over the early part of this season that has struggled some, and he's done a good job here again today mixing in enough run that this Washington defense just can't get a beat on what they're doing. Third down and 7. McNabb fires too high for Mitchell. He had Mitchell. He had him open, and he threw too high. And it shows you what kind of athlete LeVar Arrington is. He's the guy who picks up Freddie Mitchell on the crossing route, and he's running with him, of course. Freddie Mitchell's got steps on him, just unable to get the ball into his hands.
And, Troy, I know it's been a rough week for Donovan McNabb, but I also would be remiss if I didn't tell the truth. He's had a little bit of a tough day connecting on some pretty easy passes.
Punt hangs up, and Morton pulls it in at the 24. So three and out, the Redskins down by 3. Get it.
Of endless searches for low fares? Introducing Southwest Shortcut. Shows you exactly which days our lowest fares are available. Only at southwest.com.
You are now free to move about the country.
Did you know that a car hitting a wall at 40 miles per hour hits with the same force as if it fell off a 5-story building?
It's not easy getting through to teenagers today.
So at Liberty Mutual, we produced a video especially for teens about car safety. Because we'll do whatever it takes to keep them safe on the road.
Liberty Mutual, it's more than insurance. It's insurance in action.
Now for 60 miles per hour.
Wasn't that fun?
Of our audience. Any other use of this telecast or of any pictures, descriptions, or accounts of the game without the NFL's consent is prohibited.
Fox NFL Sunday is brought to you by Cadillac. Bold vehicles defying convention.
Good start for the Washington defense. They get it back to their offense. Opening minutes of the second half. Redskins have it down 3. Starting from their own 24, Ramsey hits Coles right across the field and out of bounds with a first down. Seminole on the tackle. You know, this is one of the things that Steve Spurrier really does a good job of. You're going to see Lavernius Coles line up on the outside. He motions down, which then creates problems for a defensive team, and he runs the drag route, and in essence, he winds up getting Mark Seminole that has to cover him in the zone coverage, and clearly that's a mismatch. Patrick Ramsey sees it and makes an easy completion. Only the second catch of the afternoon for Coles. Number 2 in yardage coming in. And the pass is complete. That's the tight end Royal. And he's got another Washington first down.
Well, now it looks like they're going to try and open things up here a little bit in the second half, Steve Spurrier. That was the first little break of momentum where they got a little something going with the passing game right before the first half. Sometimes that 2-minute offense can wake up an offensive team. They'd been slumbering, they hadn't been protecting, and all of a sudden now, after that momentum shift, they look pretty good coming out here to start the second half.
I know as we see Patrick Ramsey and talking with some of these Redskin coaches before the game and how his development was coming along and what he's been able to do this early in the season, winning games for this team, and they said, we know he's going to run into the wall at some point. He's going to hit the wall. He's going to struggle just like all young quarterbacks do, and we're trying to do enough with running the ball and then being very careful in what we're asking him to do in the passing game to try to delay him running into the wall as much as possible.
The wall was hitting him in the first half.
Yeah.
Wearing green. 13:02 left, third quarter. Trunk candidate. Former Ram gets it to the 47, a gain of two.
I'll tell you, though, if they can't run the football against that defensive setup, they're doubling both wideouts. They have safety help on both sides of the field. So only seven guys up there in the box for the Philadelphia Eagles, and you have to be able to run the football there in order to draw them out and try and get some man coverage on the outside.
Yeah, well, the Eagles have been tough. I mean, they've stopped the run this year mostly with seven-man fronts. Teams averaging only 2.4 yards an attempt against them, and you're right, if they're able to continue with that, they create real problems for passing games.
Big blitz coming as Ramsey changed it at the line and throws it way over the head of Gardner.
One of the things the Eagles have the capability of doing is they can audible to a blitz. In other words, if they get a formation, and that time the Redskins tried to spread it out a little bit, they can turn around and audible back here to the safeties and say, all right, I'm going now. Let's change the coverage up. So every time they get in this spread formation without a tight end, the Eagles are going to bring the pressure.
Well, Jim Johnson made it very clear. If they spread us out, we're going after them.
Play clock down to six.
Here they come again.
Ramsey over the middle, completes it. Short of a first down as candidate.
Oh boy, here comes decision time now, though.
Yeah, and you know what Steve Spurrier is wanting to do, whether or not he does what he wants to do or not, but
they are really a full yard shy of a first down, and they're going to go for it.
They're going for it. They're bringing in their big package. Zaron Flemister comes in along with Bryan Johnson at fullback. Wouldn't be surprised if they go with a little play action right here.
This is vintage Spurrier.
They hand it off, and it's Cartwright who brings up a first down. It certainly looked like he got enough for the first down.
Well, if he did, that's the second big run that Cartwright has converted. He's really become their short yardage back here today with big third down and now a big fourth down conversion.
And they got it.
Yeah, short yardage back, no pun intended. Cartwright stands 5'7", and sometimes you give the ball to a little back like that, it's hard for those defenders when he's in behind that line to see him.
Play action on first down. Ramsey steps up and fires for Coles. Juggled, incomplete, and a good play by Lewis. You think back to last year, the first three picks for the Eagles were defensive backs. Lito Shepard, then Michael Lewis, who just made that play, and Sheldon Brown.
Yeah, we're going to see Lavernius Coles, and Michael Lewis picks him up. If Ramsey's able to get that ball out towards the boundary, he's got room to run to make that play. But as you're going to see, Ramsey getting some pressure, runs right in there to ND Kalu.
Troy, I really like playing against that kind of coverage because you can get up on the safety and then run your route off of him. You're basically leaving the quarterback behind. Look for him to come back to it.
Over the middle, McCants. And Darnerien McCants stays on his feet. Penalty flag comes in at the end of the play. Nate Wayne eventually made the stop, and a flag came in very late. It's against Washington. The penalty, it looks like, came after the Redskins achieved the line to gain, and we'll see how far they mark this and what down it'll be.
After the pass was completed, illegal block in the back, offense number 87. Tenley enforced from the spot of the foul. We repeat second down.
So from the spot of the foul, the ball will be brought back to the 37, and it'll be second down and two.
It's a big penalty right there. That was a first down, and Gardner really, when the play was off and running with the late push in the back, and that's just dumb.
On second and two, Canada goes nowhere. So now third down and two.
Trent Candidate's been very productive this year, of course, coming over from the St. Louis Rams, where he didn't get much of a chance. I thought was confused a lot of the times there, had trouble holding on to the football, but averaging over 5 yards a carry coming in, but not today. He's been able to get nothing going.
From the shotgun. A handoff to Candidate, and Trung picks up a first down.
A good call right there by Steve Spurrier. The Eagles decide they're going to bring four. They played coverage, and nice job of handing it off to Trung Canada, just being one step ahead of that defense.
Good job here by Jansen coming around and lead blocking up in here. Just got a huge block against Seminole and created that first down. Boy, they haven't been getting these first downs by much, but when you get blocks like that, not too hard to convert.
They haven't been winning by much. They have a 3-1 record, this Washington team. All four games decided by 3 points or less. Down by three here. This pass is out of the reach of Royal, the tight end. He was doing a pirouette around the 15-yard line, and it was nowhere near him.
Well, just a miscommunication in what Patrick Ramsey thought he was going to run. And offensive line there, the Eagles again, they decide to only bring four guys. And when they have, this Redskins offensive line's done a nice job of giving Patrick Ramsey time to throw the football.
He's getting bumped way down the field. That's awfully close to beyond that 5-yard range. I thought he might get the call.
Second down and 10. Pass is complete. That's Taylor Jacobs. He gets to the 29, third down coming up. First catch for the rookie out of Florida.
And he really has been a disappointment, Troy, to say the least. Steve Spurrier knew him, drafted him highly in preseason. He said, hey, I tried to get him some balls. He just never performed. He ended up having a bruised pancreas. And they've been trying to work him in, but they just haven't seen enough out of him to make him a factor in the ballgame yet. Pretty tentative run there.
13th play of the drive, it's third and six.
Vernius Coles in the slot.
Here comes the blitz, though.
And penalty flags before the snap.
Full start, offense, number 60. 5-yard penalty, it's still third down.
It's really intimidating when you start seeing that corner blitz coming, and Chris Samuels knew that he was going to end up being responsible for having to try and pick up this corner that's coming out here to the outside. And he just flinches a little bit, and that's all it takes.
Yeah, and as you notice, he was flinching at the same time that Patrick Ramsey was trying to alert the wide receiver of the blitz, knowing that that receiver was going to have to make a hot route adjustment.
The numbers for Ramsey on this drive, the Redskins right at the edge of field goal range. Quick throw, the pass complete to Coles, and Lavernius Coles is brought down shy of a first down.
Now they come right back with the wide receiver screen to the other side, and although they don't get the first down, it gets them in field goal position, and now they've got a chance to come away on this drive with 3 points.
Yeah, and it's a little bit of an intimidating play for a team that likes to blitz a lot, because if you're going to send everybody up the middle, all of a sudden you flip out that screen. There's not a lot of support coming inside out from the linebacker position. So maybe that'll make Jim Johnson back off just a little bit with those blitzes.
Right at the end of the first half, Hall hit from 48. Same end of the field. This one much better looking and good as well. This game is tied. John Hall, one of the free agent pickups from the New York Jets, making an impact in the NFC East. We're tied at 13 in Philly.
SRX Performance Utility. Breakthrough.
Dear DirecTV, since 1995, I've had NFL Sunday Ticket. I haven't missed one second of any Colts game since. My wife has a horse. Its name, Peyton. Of course. Sincerely, Jimmy Jablonski.
Well, they sent a photo. I think we found our DirecTV mascot.
NFL Sunday Ticket, only from DirecTV. Act now and get a three-room DirecTV system, including equipment and installation, free.
Wardrobe.
I just want to run away. I do. I'd go anywhere with you.
His father is the district attorney.
He wants to ruin our family. He wants to destroy my business.
Can you imagine what will happen if the press gets a hold of this? They would ruin me. They would ruin you.
Why does it matter who our parents are?
You tell your son to keep his filthy hands off my daughter.
Every politician needs a target.
You cannot see this girl again ever.
The rich man's dead.
What have I done?
I love you.
I love you too.
Skin, a new series, premieres Monday, October 20th on Fox.
13-13 now as you get a look from just above the field with our flying Fox camera. Troy, I know you like the angle it can give sitting behind the quarterback as you guys try to figure out what you're looking at downfield.
Well, I do. I think over the years, a lot of different people have tried to come up with a way to show what the quarterback sees from within the pocket. I think this camera here does as good a job as any.
Ramsey saw the sky a lot in the first half. Get a shot of that.
That's easy. The kickoff from Hall is short, and it's Westbrook to the 30. 18-yard return, 30-yard line. That's where the Eagles start with it. Back where we started, tied.
To guarantee their verdict, they hired an expert from the outside.
Find something on every one of them.
But the one thing they didn't predict was someone on the inside.
The jury's mine.
And I can push it either way.
For a price.
From the best-selling thriller by John Grisham, John Cusack.
I can't protect you.
Gene Hackman.
I want you to find her.
Dustin Hoffman.
I know you're playing both sides.
Rachel Weisz.
Anyone can be gotten to.
You're losing me, my jury!
Runaway Jury. Directed by Gary Fleeter. Rated PG-13. October 17th.
Care about your car, you want to keep it protected. No one understands that like your State Farm agent.
We live where you live.
That's why more people insure their cars with State Farm than anyone else, because we care about you the way you care about your car.
Driver name it best luxury SUV for 2003? Well, there's this. 4X Motion all-wheel drive.
Beautiful.
Touareg, the Volkswagen that does what other Volkswagens don't.
Sensation, the OC, returns Wednesday, October 29th on Fox.
Outside of Chris, who forecasted this would happen, Washington, Dallas, the top two records in the NFC East. The division looks upside down with Philadelphia at the bottom. A record of 1-2 here at the start. Dallas won today. They took care of the Cardinals. And the Giants lost at home to Miami.
Of course, I predicted it 10 minutes ago.
Right, right. You didn't have to say that. First down carry, a gain of 3 by Deuce Staley.
You know, it's been a full moon kind of a week this week. And, you know, I just, so many things with Donovan McNabb and all that. But, Troy, in so many ways, I really think that sports is ahead of the rest of society when it comes to some of the racial issues. And, guys, when you live together, you better learn how to get along.
Donovan McNabb having to answer question after question.
with the controversy, and now he is sacked back at the 25-yard line. They got great pressure up front by the two guys who get no credit, Halsey and Haley, and they were both there to bring down McNabb.
Well, they sure were. Yeah, they haven't been able to get a whole lot of pressure inside with those guys, but Halsey comes through, and boy, Donovan didn't even see him coming at all, and why should he? He's a defensive tackle. He should have been blocked up on the play, but nice job getting pressure up inside. That's something they've not had much of.
Well, I praised Bobby Williams before, but it looks like he blew that one. Remember, he's filling in for Jermaine Mayberry, the Pro Bowler, and he just took the wrong guy that time.
Play clock is winding down to four. And it's third and 15. McNabb fires, and the pass is caught.
Oh, that's too good.
Thrash.
That's too good. I tell you, even if you're as good as Champ Bailey, that stop route on the outside is almost impossible. Just stride for stride, and McNabb threw it long before he stopped, and Thrash just able to turn around and make the play.
Well, you just can't defend it. You're over the top, and what a lot of these teams, when they get a defender over the top, they'll run that fade stop, and as a corner, as you mentioned, Chris, there's just nothing you can do. Once you turn around to locate the ball, which Champ does, you've got Thrash stopping and coming back, and the ball's already there.
Great throw. Great throw on that.
First down for Philadelphia in what is now a 13-13 game. McNabb brought down from behind. Pepe Zellner was there to grab him by the shoulder pads, and the pass was incomplete.
Yeah, Pepe Zellner doing a nice job of staying home along with Jesse Armstead. Donovan comes out on the boot thinking he may have some lane to run, but because those guys stayed home, there was nothing really that he could do with it. We see Bruce Smith come off the field, and how about him?
How about it? Look at his arm.
Amazing. Well, not, that's amazing in itself.
40-year-old man.
I mean, for him to be doing what he's been doing for that long is pretty remarkable.
He wants that record, though. He
yes, he does.
He wants that record. Two more to go.
But they'll tell you he's been playing the run better this year as Westbrook is knocked down right at midfield, falls forward just into Washington territory, a gain of five.
And I think, Chris, to go back to kind of what you were talking about with Donovan McNabb, and you know, you can only imagine what he's been through. The guy just wants to go play football, and he takes his team to two consecutive NFC championship games. Next thing he knows, he's winning a game at Buffalo, a hard-fought game, and then all heck breaks loose once he gets back to Philadelphia after that. But I've always said that if I were an owner or a head coach in this league, there's nobody I would like more being the spokesman or the quarterback for my team than Donovan McNabb. He does a great job handling those kinds of issues,
and he proved that all week long. Third down and five. Pass is complete, and Westbrook is drilled. Jesse Armstead, the longtime Giant, came up, made the hit. What a play by the veteran, and it's time for a Philadelphia punt.
You know, Jesse Armstead is one of those exciting football players. He takes chances on the field. I can remember a game earlier this year, he got a safety against the Atlanta Falcons. Warrick Dunn was swinging out in the flat, but he thought he could get there, so he just rips up in there, and it could have been a 98-yard touchdown pass, but he has so much speed, so much quickness, and when he turns it on,
as
boy, is it
the receiver
explosive.
Hit the ground, the ball rolled out and hit the ground, therefore the pass was incomplete. It's fourth down.
So they're calling fourth down, and now they'll have to move the football back to midfield. The punt unit will stay on the field for Philadelphia, as it's fourth down and five instead of fourth down and more than 10.
Has the momentum shifted in this game or what? I
Without
mean, it really is now moved all the way over to the Washington Redskins side, and defensively, they've really picked it up.
Movement, but no flags. And Morton hauls it in. Gets to the 16 and takes a seat. Hood brought him down, a 5-yard return. After tying it, the Redskins get it back. 13-13 in Philadelphia.
They said its off-road capabilities verged on overkill.
Torag.
They said others may be as quick, capable, and handle as sharply, but few can match it on all of the above.
Torag.
They said it was everything you could want in a luxury SUV, but for 20 grand less. In fact, the only thing the experts couldn't say?
Touareg.
Toural.
Twarg.
Was the name.
Touareg.
Introducing the Touareg. Easily named car and driver's best luxury SUV for 2003.
Ah, here's the fun. And the original ones. Dr. Pepper.
You know, some interesting facts about Delaware, guys. It was the first state to ratify the Constitution. Thank you, forefathers. Man, am I glad we wrote that thing up. Each article, I mean, we'll cover all the articles, but... North Carolina. Horse population of 220,000. A lot of hooves, too, almost a million. A lot of hay. You know, what is hay, exactly? Is it wheat? You know, I dated a girl named Georgia.
For when you need it most, our longest-lasting Energizer Max ever.
After that, I told myself...
Do you have the bunny inside?
I am not dating girls named after states.
Fox NFL Sunday is brought to you by Southwest Airlines. Friendly nonstop service all across the country. Southwest Airlines, a symbol of freedom. By Dr. Pepper and your local Dr. Pepper bottler. Be you, nothing's better, Dr. Pepper. By Runaway Jury, October 17th, only in theaters. And by Volkswagen. On the road of life, there are passengers and there are drivers.
Now the Redskins go to work. Backed up at their own 16-yard line, Patrick Ramsey. And a tie game in Philadelphia. Hands the ball to Betts. And he's brought down behind the line of scrimmage. Loss of two. And now a penalty flag comes in at the end of the play.
Darwin Walker's a stud, though, isn't he? Moved outside, played some defensive end for this team when they had all the injuries. Looks like he grabbed a face mask.
That looks like the 15-yard line.
I think so, too.
Yeah, they're going to get him for that, but you're right, Chris. He is really, he's been pretty versatile in what they've asked
him to do.
Personal
foul, face mask, defense. It's a 15-yard penalty enforced from the dead ball spot, which is also the spot of the foul. 15 yards, first down.
What a huge penalty that is against the Eagles to get a little breathing room for the Redskins.
Good point, Joe. Darwin Walker now back inside because Brandon Whiting's been able to return to the lineup. So this is a formidable front.
Under 4.5 to play in the third quarter. And now movement again. Looks like this time they got the tight end, Robert Royal.
Start offense, number 88, 5-yard penalty, still first down.
They had man coverage, and I think Ramsey that time saw that Betts was on the outside when he flanked him out wide. He had a linebacker walked out on him and probably wanted to check to some sort of a pass to try and take advantage of it. Every time they try and check, they go 5 yards backwards.
We have not seen any changes by Ramsey result in any big plays. It's not even worth it. And you can't continually overcome first and 15 against a good defensive football team. Doing it again. Play clock down to two. And now Ramsey in trouble and sacked. Darwin Walker. Yeah, he's not getting away from that one. Darwin Walker, the strongest player on this defensive line, and he's inside, and he's just able to put a pretty good move here. He's playing in front of Hollis Thomas because he's a better pass rusher. Splits the gap there. Once he gets his meat hooks on Ramsey, he's coming down.
And Derek Dockery looks slow coming off the ball. I don't know if he couldn't hear the snap count or not, but allowed Walker to split the gap and split the double team. Well, I tell you, you want to drive yourself crazy. Have a guy double teamed and have him make a sack.
Second down and 19. Another quick move by Walker, and that is up for grabs. Intercepted, Kalu. Into the end zone for the touchdown. Darwin Walker is going to shoot the gap again. He's the one who allows this to happen. Gets pressure on Ramsey, hits his hand. Indy Kalu on the other side of it, sees it coming, and is able to make the interception. Jim Johnson just the other day said Indy Kalu is on the verge of a breakout game. I don't know if this is necessarily it, but a great play there by Indy Kalu, established by Darwin Walker. Akers drills it to make it a 7-point game. 15-yard return by the former Washington Redskin, N.D. Kalu. Darwin Walker made it happen, and the Eagles on defense regain the lead.
You know what you never see in car commercials? Real cars. Cars that have been around the block a few times. The kinds of cars that need Castrol GTX high mileage. Specially engineered to protect against oil burn-off better than other leading motor oils. Castrol GTX high mileage. It helps older cars feel young again.
I want to thank you guys for coming out. Oh, Jamie. Why don't you tell us what's new in IT?
Gotta keep it short.
Oh, well, we just implemented DFS and a new SAN. And also, we enabled shadow copy for shared folders on our file servers. It enables users to get back lost documents on their own without calling IT. And it'll save us hundreds of thousands of dollars, which...
It'll do what?
With new Windows Server 2003, you can do more with less.
Automated system recovery.
As a United Way volunteer, Darren Howard helps out in a drama program that helps kids express themselves.
Action.
Badges? We don't need any sting of badges.
Now that was a good one.
Fox NFL Sunday is brought to you by Microsoft. Your potential, our passion.
Well, you talked about the momentum switching in favor of the Redskins just moments ago, but defensively, it's the Eagles who take control now, up by 7. And it's Darwin Walker who made it happen on the last two plays. ND Kalu gets a gift. A nice return for the touchdown, his first interception. And the Eagles are out in front 20-13. And with that wind, you can't say there's no wind whipping around down on that field, even with the flags pretty much still, as the ball is blown off the tee, and they're going to have somebody, Roderick Hood, hold it for David Akers on this kickoff. And if you're not used to doing this, Roderick Hood, you're going to get a nice little charge when that ball shoots out of your hand off the foot of David Akers. Yeah, that finger came off before the foot got to the ball. I don't blame him. Chad Morton on the return. Good return by Morton. He is out to the 27.
Derek Dockery, the left guard, is absolutely killing the Redskins right now. This is a slide protection. Everybody goes this way. He's slow and allows Walker to shoot right through there. That is his man. He gave up that touchdown. That's two straight plays now. He's blown his protection.
I think part of the problem also, though, Chris, is that the Redskins are having problems adjusting snap count, and so I think they probably had to go to something simple, and the defensive line for the Eagles know this because Darwin Walker got a great jump on both of those two plays. He almost beat the offensive lineman coming out of a snap.
The rookie just looks unsure of his assignments. Dave Fiore unable to go because of a knee injury, and it's really hurting the Redskins right now.
On first down, they hand a candidate. And a pickup of one. Old David Akers, the tough guy kicker. He's the best in Eagles history, and even he was getting hot and mixing it up at the end of the play. Taking on Antonio Pierce. I think he better just get back to the sideline. Crowd loved it.
I think he realized it, too. Look at him, though, man. His shoulders are back. He's all bowed up.
Second down and 9. And that was thrown right into the teeth of the coverage. Lavernius Coles, the intended receiver. Shepard was there. Let's go for a game break. Here's JB.
Joe Buck, San Francisco, starting to expand his lead. Joey Harrington threw a pick. Three plays later, Jeff Garcia on the boot. He takes it in. 14-point lead, San Fran over Detroit. That in the third. Back to Joe Buck.
Third and 9. Over the middle, the pass incomplete. Gardner, the intended receiver, and he was covered by Sheldon Brown.
And Troy, I think the story of this game right now is the Redskins' inability to run the football is allowing the Eagles and Jim Johnson to protect this young secondary. They're not playing man coverage. They're not in one-on-one situations. They have a lot of defensive backs back there. Awfully tough to throw the football in that.
Pretty good punt by Barker. Westbrook from inside the 25. Out to the 38, 16-yard return. What's coming up tonight? Well, I'll be sitting in front of my TV watching game five of this division series, the Cubs and the Braves. Sammy Sosa and those Cubs. Kerry Wood and the way he pitched the first game of that series against Mike Hampton, who really pitched well down the stretch for Atlanta. Turned in a good start in game two. That's the matchup tonight at 7:30 Eastern, 4:30 Pacific on Fox.
Joe, obviously you cover baseball a heck of a lot more than what I do, but I wonder if Dusty Baker has gotten the recognition that he deserves for what he's done with that Chicago team.
And he was a guy who went in a game five last year with the Giants and won in the division series in Atlanta, and he's back there with the Cubs, same situation. McNabb has plenty of room to run, and he slides short of a first down. Gain of 8.
Well, and that's what we've grown to see and get accustomed to from Donovan McNabb. He drops back. Defense does a good job covering his receivers, but he's got a big lane and he takes it. This is when he's at his dangerous. We talk about him sitting in the pocket and trying to throw the football, but you can't take this away from Donovan McNabb. You can't make him something that he's not. And he's dangerous when he gets on the move.
Second down and 2. This is Staley. And that's a first down at midfield.
You just wonder now if the Redskins and George Edwards may have to start taking a few chances here. They've been able to play pretty conservatively on the defensive side. A lot of zone defense. Their goal this year, not give up the big plays. But now you're starting to get down to that point in the ball game where if the Eagles can march it down here and come up with a field goal the way the Redskins offense is playing right now, I just don't imagine that they're going to be able to make some sort of a comeback. So you need a big defensive play right here.
How refreshing is it in today's NFL to see a quarterback and wide receiver sitting next to each other on the bench? Especially a big money wide receiver who has not had much of an impact in the game. Cole's only 3 catches, yet there they sit, not arguing or throwing anything at each other.
Well, he should be very happy, Lavernius Coles, that is, for the job that Patrick Ramsey has done through this season. He's done a great job, obviously, of getting him the football. And we take a look at what Philadelphia is doing offensively, and it appears that they are going to try to grind this thing out as best they can and take some time off this clock. They've run the ball here the last couple of times, and it appears that's what they're going to continue with.
This could be the final play of the third quarter. Pass is complete. Seldom used Billy McMullen. And he falls forward to the 44, a gain of 3.
That's a big tackle by Olaite there. He really looked like he was in a tough position and made an open field tackle to give him a chance here on third down.
And with that, it's the end of the third quarter. Donovan McNabb just completed his 1,000th career pass in the NFL. It'll be third down for the Eagles when we come back. They lead by 7. The NFL on Fox will continue after a word from your local Fox station.
You're watching the NFL on Fox.
No matter where I travel, one thing remains the same. Everybody loves Ford here in the Lone Star State.
And it's easy to see why, especially when you consider the wide range of SUVs you'll find at your Texas Ford dealer. Not to mention the incredible deals. As low as 0% for 72 months or cash rebates up to $4,500 on select Explorer, Excursion, Expedition, and Escape models at your Texas Ford dealer.
Is it a marvel of engineering? A triumph of technology? Or a new benchmark of design? Yes. Introducing the new LS from Lexus.
In a home where comedy is king.
Oh, my God.
Two kings of comedy collide.
You are in for the joust of your life, mister.
You are a selfish bastard.
Weeknights on Fox 26. History is made.
I'll see you in hell.
Hearts are broken.
Game over, Bobby.
And beer is slammed. King of the Hill. The King of Queens. Weeknights on Fox 26.
It's great to be the king.
The Rockets Liftoff with Jeff Van Gundy, Sunday on Sports Extra.
The Eagles with the lead and the ball and a third down.
Huge moment in the ball game right now.
Well, it is, and the Redskins have not been good on third down at all, converting 40% for the Eagles on third down. It's third down and four. Guys moving all over the place. And McNabb flushed. Has nowhere to throw it, and there's a big stop by the Redskins defense. Jesse Armstead and Bernard Holsey. Well, you see Donovan McNabb, he comes back. He's ready to throw. It looks like he's trying to get the ball to Thrash and got a little bit of pressure and had to start moving to the outside at that time. And of course, there's Pinkston on the backside. He's running the drag route, and there's Jesse Armstead.
Yeah, that's
that
got what I saw.
That one.
I saw Fred Smoot grab a jersey. I thought I saw that when I was watching it the first time around. Big hold by the Redskins.
Johnson with a punt. Chad Morton will let it go over his head and into the end zone. So now the Washington Redskins will get it. They are trailing by seven, and we're still standing here.
Yeah.
And that was a big stand there. You mentioned it just before the play by the Washington defense.
Yeah, and now this Redskins offense, though, has to do something, and they really haven't. Remember, we had the touchdown right after the Trotter play, the interception, and really, for the most part, the Redskins have been pretty inept on the offensive side.
Well, they have been, but the one thing they have going in their favor is that they're accustomed to playing in these close ball games, and so they are not out of this, obviously. I mean, they're in the ball game, and even though they haven't done much up to this point, Ramsey has shown an ability to get a team back in a game. From their own 20. And here's Ramsey again, changing it up at the line. Down the sideline, Gardner was wide open. But he's overthrown.
Well, they turned him loose, Joe.
They had him up the sideline. The safety's trying to get over to the top to give him some help, but Sheldon Brown just lets him go.
You know, but Troy, the single coverage was on the other side of the field. I think Ramsey just misread that. He had safety help on that side, but down at the bottom, Lito Shepard was one-on-one against Lavernius Coles.
But I think with that go route that he had, when Sheldon Brown leveled off, I think he might have been able to stick one in there at about 15 yards prior to safety getting there. And movement by the left tackle. It sure seemed, at least, Samuels. We'll see if they get the flag.
Ball start.
I'll tell you what.
Offense, number 60. 5-yard penalty. Second down.
Spurrier has got to be thoroughly upset right now with what's going on. You're going to see Chris Samuels at left foot right there is all it took. Indy Kalu knocks him down. But as we've talked about, this has been an ongoing problem, and you just cannot have those kinds of mistakes when you're trying to win a football game. Five false start penalties in this game for Washington. On second down and 15, left all alone is Morton out of the backfield. And the little guy scoots across the 25 to the 26. Third down coming up.
I like what the Redskins did there. They go back into the shotgun formation. They go to the silent snap count. You saw Ramsey just simply lift his leg. So take it out. And I also would be telling Ramsey right now, listen, no more audibles. This game's... You know, the crowd's into it. It's really noisy out here. Whatever I call it, just run it.
On third down and four, off the shoulder pad of Morton and incomplete.
Oh, boy.
That ball was a little bit behind him, but I think Chad should have been able to bring that one in. And if he does, he gets the first down easily. And because it was man-to-man, he's got a lot of room out there to run. And Chad Morton's been a big part of this team over the last or over the first few games in third down. But boy, what a critical drop there.
Boy, and that was Nate Wayne, who already had to go out of the game with a bad hip. He tried to get it to him quickly. If he had a chance to just let him run, he would have been out the gate.
Westbrook waiting for the Barker punt and a fair catch. They'll mark him down just outside the 35. Chris Samuel saying it's hard to hear. It must be. Five false start penalties have hurt Washington today.
Sunday, Sunday, see Big Eddie haul trees in his fueling jacket, Hemi Dodge Ram 1500. Sunday, Sunday, Big Eddie picks up stuff in his 345 horsepower Hemi Dodge Ram. Sunday, Sunday, going fishing in a Hemi powered Ram.
Morning, Ed.
Monday, Monday.
You gotta stop.
Looking so long at these pictures of you, you never hold on to your heart. Looking so long for the real voice to be true, you always just breaking apart my pictures of you.
Welcome to HP Digital Photography. HP, invent.
Wireless troubles?
My phone works here, not there. Same with voicemail, email.
Sprint is different. All your services work the same wherever you go, on the most complete, all-digital, advanced wireless network in the nation. And all the calls are clear.
So everything works.
And this will never happen again.
PCS from Sprint. Try the nation's most complete wireless network.
Fox NFL Sunday is brought to you by Dodge. You can take life as it comes, or you can grab life by the horns. Dodge. By HP. HP technology, services, and people help make more things more possible. By Subway. Good so you don't always have to be. Subway. Eat fresh. And by new Gillette Sensor 3.
There's a look for you.
Yeah, that's a... He's got his crash helmet on. That's great, isn't it?
Looks like at one point that thing had a face mask.
You know, at the vet, every person at the game had to wear one of those.
No kidding. On first down, it's McNabb. Has it batted down, and it drops incomplete. Let's go back to that third down opportunity for Washington.
Play of the game so far, you've got Chad Morton with a perfect situation going singled up against Nate Wayne. And if Ramsey can just let him release a little bit further, would have been wide open and easy. But I'll tell you what, for Morton, that's just, got to catch that ball. That's ball game on the line right there. And that's his specialty, coming out of the backfield and being a receiver.
The other benefit for Ramsey, had he held it, Morton could have gotten away from the umpire who was sitting right in the middle of that play. It's second down and 10. Play action from McNabb. Over the middle. That's the tight end, L.J. Smith. And the pass completed for 4 yards. Ball popped out, but they're going to say that Smith was down. And let's go to Los Angeles for a game break and check in again with JB.
Hey, Joe, Steve Mariucci's Lions refused to fold on an 8-play, 60-yard drive. They cap it with that 2-yard run by Olandis Gary, a Washington, D.C. area native. It is now 24-17, San Francisco. Back to Joe, Troy, Chris, and Pam.
Detroit came close a week ago, JB, with that effort at Denver. And now they're trying to make some noise late in San Francisco. Here it's 20-13 Eagles. And they're faced with 3rd and 6. McNabb under pressure again, and he's brought down short of a first down. Bruce Smith and Reagan Upshaw, two veterans, were there for the pressure. And another punt coming up from the Eagles.
And secondary locking up on the outside, knowing that he's only going to try to get it to the chains. They didn't give him any room to throw the football, and Donovan did about all he could, trying to get up inside the pocket, but just unable to get enough yards for the first down.
Wobbly kick from Johnson. Morton. Falls forward to the 26, and it's a 6-yard return. So the Redskins get it back. Good work today by the Washington defense.
Donald, you shouldn't eat that way. It's okay, I had Subway for lunch.
Subway, delicious low-fat sandwiches, so you can feel good about being good and okay about being bad.
There's no easy way to say this. Just kidding! You're fine! It's okay. I had Subway. I can't look at your face!
Subway, good, so you don't always have to be.
Hey, Donovan! Surprise!
It's not my yard.
If you really want tickets to the game, just use your Visa. It's the card you know they'll take everywhere you want to be. Visa.
Hey, you!
Proud sponsor of the NFL.
I break for yard sales.
I break for little old ladies. Donuts.
Boys. UFOs.
I break for free oil changes.
Visit your local Midas mechanic now and get a free oil change with any Midas brake job. That's free oil and filter with any new brakes.
This Friday, go for the kill. Ebert and Roper give Kill Bill two thumbs way up.
No kidding.
Absolute dynamite. Hmm. It will blow you away. Quentin Tarantino's Kill Bill. Rated R.
This October, Fox is telling these beautiful European women that this $11,000 a year cowboy is worth $80 million in oil. We lied. Again.
And now to the best part, he's rich.
The next Joe Millionaire, an international affair. Monday, October 20th on Fox.
Donovan McNabb and that offense gathered around Brad Childress trying to figure out a way to move the ball against this Washington defense. Last point scored by the Philadelphia defense on that interception return for a touchdown by Kalu. Redskins hand off. This is Morton. He gets out to the 32, a gain of 6.
It's interesting. Spurrier telling us last night that Chad Morton, every time he gets into the ball game, is basically just a receiver. And the other teams seem to know that. At some point or another, we're going to have to hand him the football, and just so they believe he can run the ball back there as well.
Well, on that last defensive play, they had 7 defensive backs in the game. They have now substituted. Now they're a conventional front. Second down and 4. Cartwright. Penalty flag on the play as Cartwright spins forward, brought down right at the marker. They're going to call a trip against Washington.
Looks like Corey Simon was being held on that play.
Tripping by the offense, number 66. 10-yard penalty, repeat second down.
That's Dockery, who has had a rough second half.
I was out on the field, and Troy, you were too, with Kim Helton, the offensive line coach, before the ball game. And he was saying that last week, at least I didn't notice Dockery. You know, he didn't lose the game for us in any way, and that's a good sign for young offensive linemen. Today, that is not the case. Missing Dave Fiore has been huge in this ball game.
Marginal call. It brings up second down and 14 and took a first down away from the Redskins. McCants. And a penalty flag comes in. A late hit on Ramsey. Well, that's going to be a big penalty there tacked on to the play.
At what price, though?
Marco Coleman, a former Washington Redskin, hit him late. They keep talking about the toughness of Patrick
Personal
Ramsey.
Foul,
he certainly is.
The passer, defense number 97.
Ooh.
Four under the quarterback's head. 15-yard penalty from the end of the run. First down.
So it was Coleman the last one there, but it was Walker who swooped in there literally and gave Ramsey that little shot up to the neck or head.
Yeah, it was. I mean, it was a big-time blow. He didn't have to make the hit. He had time to pull off, but what a great throw by Patrick Ramsey when he's getting pressure, and then he's able to throw a perfect pass to Darnerien McCants out there on the sidelines. And that's the type of stuff I've seen from Patrick Ramsey in the previous games. And there's not a lot of quarterbacks that can sit in there under duress and deliver the football on time like he has done.
15 yards on the completion to McCants, and another 15 on the penalty. Quick setup and throw, and a pass complete to Gardner, who's wrestled down at the 40. How about a baseball game break? Let's go back to James Brown in Los Angeles.
Hey, Joe, take a look at what the Yankees did here, capping a six-run fourth inning here. Alfonso Soriano slapping that two-run single. The Yankees close out the series over the Twins with an 8-1 victory. And tonight, it'll be a Game 5 deciding game between the Chicago Cubs and the Atlanta Braves. Wood and Hampton on the mound. Back to Joe Buck.
On second down, Ramsey fires, and it's McCants again with a reception for a first down.
Well, they come right back to the same route, same throw that they had earlier when they had roughing the passer, and they're just running a corner route against some of this coverage, and Patrick Ramsey is laying it out there on the sideline. As you can see, it allows them to run away from the defender. Patrick Ramsey throwing this ball very well.
They're starting to take advantage now of some of these young defensive backs that are out there for the Eagles. Brutally that time, being victimized.
That's knocked down. And a good play by Michael Lewis, the strong safety, coming up on one of the many Jim Johnson blitz.
Well, yeah, they bring Michael Lewis off the slot on the blitz. And one thing you can count on is that when an offense starts moving the football against the Eagles, Jim Johnson is not just going to sit back in zones and allow them the luxury of throwing the football. He is going to get pressure on the quarterback. I wouldn't at all be surprised if he brings some sort of blitz here either.
Second down and 10. Pressure from the corner. And again, Ramsey is just flattened. This time it's Clinton Hart.
Wait, the one problem that you have when you have a great athlete like Chad Morton in the backfield, he's a very small guy, and it seems that every time Chad Morton's been in there, they are bringing to his side all the pressure. Now, he did a nice job picking it up there, but it's getting a little predictable now. They're coming to that side because they don't think he can block it.
Well, the Eagles do a great job of overloading one side, making you think it's coming from there, and then backing him out and bringing the blitz the opposite way.
Ramsey's 3 of 11 on third down. Has time. And instead of pulling it in and running, he kept pointing downfield, and that may have cost them a first down as Darwin Walker makes the tackle from behind.
Well, it's a great point, Joe, because Patrick Ramsey is not necessarily known as a runner, but yet he has made some big runs this season to help this football team win games. If he takes the ball here, once he starts moving up in the pocket, if he makes the decision there to tuck it and run, he's going to pick up the first down. There's nobody there.
And they had man coverage choice, so everybody was running away from it. He might have scored on
that.
That
was great effort by Darwin Walker making the play.
37-yard try by John Hall. Good snap, good hold, and the kick is perfect. That makes this a four-point game. Under 9 minutes to play in Philadelphia, and the Redskins crawl a little closer.
Hey, that thing got an Emmy?
You're about to find out.
Excuse me. Can I have my order, please?
Dodge Ram with the legendary Hemi. Loved by those who have one, dreamt about by those who don't.
Sweet.
Retirement. It's a lot more enjoyable when Lincoln's looking out for you. See your financial advisor or call 1-877-ASK-LINCOLN for details.
Maybe I don't own a fancy building or a big shipping department yet. But Brown still takes my business seriously.
I can print labels, track shipments, order a pickup right from here.
And with the time I save, I can build my business. Maybe I'm not exactly part of the limousine set, but I have a driver.
Small business shipping. Synchronized. UPS. What can Brown do for you? Wood and the Cubs take on Chipper and the Braves in decisive Game 5. Next.
Fox NFL Sunday is brought to you by UPS. What can Brown do for you?
Congratulations to the New York Yankees doing what they couldn't do last year, and that is get into the American League Championship Series here. Fun game. We've seen a little bit of everything, and it's a 20-16 lead for the Eagles, who so far are winless, preseason included, in their new stadium. They'll get it back on the kickoff from Hall, and Westbrook will take it from just outside the five. Out to the 30. And that's where Donovan McNabb and this Philadelphia offense will set up, leading by four, to go back and recap. Four-yard touchdown throw to John Ritchie. First touchdown pass of the season for McNabb, who was later picked off by Jeremiah Trotter, the former Eagle, which set up a Patrick Ramsey touchdown run. And then Andy Kalu with an interception and a 15-yard return for the go-ahead touchdown. The day for McNabb as he is up to 1,000 completions in his NFL career. Kalu and that touchdown on the interception return the difference so far. Handoff is to Westbrook. There is nowhere to go. And I've really been impressed, guys, with the play of this Washington defense.
Well, I really have, yeah. And you talk about their defense, and really the strength of that is these linebackers. Jesse Armstead has been all over the field. Of course, Jeremiah Trotter and the interception that he got. But, yeah, the defense is really starting to pick it up. They played well.
And they've been doing it while still helping in the secondary. That front seven alone has been able to stop the run, and the Eagles have really struggled trying to run the football so far. A lot of pressure on this Eagles team. They cannot afford to go 1-3 with three losses at home this early in the season.
Showing blitz and coming with it are the Redskins. Trotter got there late, and Smoot turned around too late with Pinkston, the intended receiver.
And it's probably a good thing Fred Smoot did get turned around too late, because he might have intercepted it had he have gotten his head around.
There's a penalty flag on that last play, and John Runyon is down and not moving.
A really late penalty flag. Yes, he is moving now. Probably got knocked out, wouldn't you say?
Who knows, but he went down and was face first and not budging, and they were screaming to the sideline to get somebody out there to help him. Everybody was watching. First of all, Trotter coming. He got there just a little late defensively for Washington. And then
after the play was over, personal foul, unnecessary roughness defense, number 91, 15-yard penalty, first down.
Huge mistake and penalty committed by Reagan Upshaw. And Runyon is able to hop up and almost literally sprint off the field.
Well, there's Reagan Upshaw engaged with John Runyon, and John Runyon getting another blow there, and that's the one they see. They always see the last one, and Reagan Upshaw retaliates, knocks John Runyon down, and he got the foul. That's, you're right, that's a big penalty. They had stopped him there, and now you add that 15 yards on, and now they're in midfield.
John Runyon has a way of drawing those kind of fouls
looks
out
like
of guys.
He, looks like he sold that a little
I
bit,
I was
too.
Wondering if he did a little acting job on the end of that one as well.
Especially when you consider he got up and just ran off the field after the call.
Well, let's just see if he comes back in right after this play.
You want to bet?
They're not even looking at him. They're not even looking at him over there. The pass is behind Thrash. No penalty flag on the play, and Runyon comes right back onto the field.
Yeah, I think the first, you know, of course, the only reason he came out the first time was because if you send a trainer out, then you have to come off the field for one play, and he did his obligatory one play sit out.
The first Academy Award nomination of the season goes to John Runyon. He's a beauty. He got exactly what he wanted.
Second down and 10. And the handoff is to Westbrook. Running right, he gets to midfield. And it'll be third and 5 coming up.
Well, that's what they did a week ago. They just stayed with this running game, even though it wasn't very effective. They were only averaging about 2.5 yards a carry. And all of a sudden, at the end of the ball game, Westbrook broke one out to clinch it.
And I'm not so sure that Donovan has really gotten comfortable yet in this game. You know, last week he talked about how he was seeing things much better, but so far today he's not thrown the ball particularly well. On third down, McNabb got nowhere to go with it, so he'll run a race, and he falls forward for a first down. What an effort. Jeremiah Trotter tripped him up, but McNabb knew exactly where to go, and he got enough for a first down.
Looked like Ronaldo Nehemiah on that one. He had to get to the sticks. He can see him. He's running right towards him. And what's this high hurdle? Skeets would have been proud. You know, the interesting part there is, was he touched? Because if he were not touched, that ball would have been free.
Question is, when he did that little leap, was he touched on his way down to the ground?
I mean, it's not going to matter because they blew the play dead, so you can't challenge it. But if he were not touched.
Well, one thing about it is, Rashad Bauman, he's got to come up and try to at least hit McNabb up in the pads. I mean, how many times do you see a DB go at someone's feet in a play like that, a critical third down play, and you're unwilling to come in and hit the guy, and you lay in there with your shoulder? You see it time after time. That's a big play right there. That's a big first down for this Eagles offense.
Well, Bauman is outweighed by 60 pounds by Donovan McNabb. You can get a challenge, but I believe the officials and Ed Hockley is going to say, listen, coach, it doesn't matter. You can't challenge that play.
I just think
Washington is challenging a ruling on that the runner got beyond the first down line for first down.
You wonder if Ed Hockley went over and said, look, you can't challenge that aspect of it, but if you want to challenge the spot, you can. You could see Bauman got a piece of the leg of McNabb on his way down, and then the knee went down. They gave Donovan that last little lunge, which is exactly what got the Eagles the first down. Now, you just don't know if we've got an angle here to where they can determine definitively where the ball is when the knee's down. The knee's down there. Now, the ball from this angle is not yet to the line. That's tough. That's tough. I mean, obviously, from this angle, it's a little bit off. And so as a result of that, you review it to see where the spot is. And I don't know that they overturn it. Here's a little better look at it. I don't think there's anything there to suggest that they can overturn the call.
I agree.
I just think Bauman should have hit him in the pads.
Hey, you got to give old Donovan a little credit there, bro. That was Kathy Rigby would have been proud of that move, man. I'll tell you what, that was, talk about athletic quarterbacks. Donovan McNabb's one of the guys at the top of that list. Phenomenal play by him, not Bauman.
Yeah, it really was a good play by McNabb. He actually was looking to come the other way to Brian Westbrook on a swing route and covered it up pretty good. So that's when he took off scrambling to his left, and a great athletic job by Donovan McNabb to pick that one up.
You know, what was really remarkable, though, was that he was able to get both feet down to lunge forward. I mean, he was literally being spun around on that move and somehow managed to get that left foot back down just to push off and go back forward and dive for the first down.
Ed Hockley is still looking at the play, and I think we are all in agreement that there's just not enough there to determine exactly where the ball should be placed if they're not going to give the Eagles the first down.
You know, the other thing is they've already moved the chain, so it's not like they're going to be able to mark this thing and then bring it back. So this yellow line that's not really supposed to be in play may well come in play as far as Hockley is concerned, because it appeared to be pretty obvious that the ball was over the yellow line that we have on the television screen.
The ruling on the field stands as called. The result of the play was a first down.
There's just not enough there, because on top of it, the flag was right there on
the yard line, which is the 45-yard line. So then you'd have to get into literally inches as to where you would place it, even if you said his knee was down and he didn't cross the line.
Well, it was a good job by the officials, and it was worth the challenge if you're Steve Spurrier. I mean, it's worth taking a shot. That's a critical play in this game. Obviously keeps the drive alive, and what the Redskins have to do here defensively is they've got to hold them to nothing more than a field goal. And if they get just 20 more yards, they're going to be in position for an attempt.
I'll tell you, though, that timeout is going to come back to haunt them here. But you have to at least hold the Eagles to a field goal to keep it within a touchdown.
Of course, with the leg of Akers, I'm not even sure you have to get that much more yards.
Yeah, they're almost in field goal range right now. And that's not an exaggeration.
No. But if you decide to kick one this far and miss, the field position really changes.
It's a first down for the Eagles, and it's Staley. New Staley to the 41, a gain of three.
They're really important now for this Redskins defense, again, to make some sort of a stand here. You're out there, and probably my guess is you're going to force Andy Reid to punt the football unless they can pick up another 4 or 5 yards and get really close to the first down marker at least. So these 4 or 5 yards critical at this point.
Yeah, they get 4 yards there on the ground on first down. And you know, if they're able to run the ball here and get first down, not only do they keep the ball, but then they're taking a lot more time off the clock.
Second down and 7. They throw and wide open is Richie. The fullback has a first down for Philadelphia.
Boy, just an unbelievable lack of pressure that time by the Redskins. I don't know if this defensive line's getting tired or the offensive line's just doing a great job, but there is just nothing there. McNabb had to go through all 5 receivers before he finally found Richie, and it just kind of a dog effort on the part of the Redskins up front.
5.5 to punt. First down, Staley.
Play's over, man.
Tiptoes his way to the 29. Gain of 2. Tonight coming up, it's game 5 of the National League Division Series. The Chicago Cubs and Kerry Wood against the Atlanta Braves and Mike Hampton. That's on at 7:30 Eastern time right here on Fox. And then tomorrow, game 5, Boston and Oakland. It's an 8 p.m. Eastern start. Pedro Martinez will be on the mound for the Boston Red Sox as they get through a start today where they sent Burkett to the hill. The big 8th inning won it for the Red Sox to force game 5. Second down and 8, and the pass is Pinkston. He gets to the 24, that's all, and it's third down coming up.
I'll tell you what, Andy Reid is showing the confidence that he has in Donovan McNabb throwing the football down here when they're still in pretty good position. They can run the football, but he's putting the ball into his best player's hands. And right now, Donovan's been smart with the decisions that he's made, and he's completed these passes, which has also kept the clock running.
Certainly, statistically speaking, not a great day for Donovan McNabb. And it's been a start to the season filled with that. It's third down and 3. Toss to Westbrook, has blocking in front of him, and a first down for the Eagles. Big Trey Thomas was out there, and behind Thomas, Westbrook dives for a first down.
Chad Lewis's motion just got the Redskins outflanked, going to come across right here, and now they get everybody hooked on the outside. Pull the offensive line, get them out front with Trey Thomas. Tremendous play call by Andy Reid. Just had him out position that time.
Well, it really was. You come back on second down, which is a running down in this situation. You throw the ball on 3rd and 3. You think you're going to get past. They run the sweep. Just keeping them on their heels.
Now they stay on the ground. Westbrook. Touchdown, Eagles.
Troy, exactly the way they clinched it a week ago.
It was a back-breaking run by Brian Westbrook at Buffalo, a 62-yarder. And now this, 19 yards for a big Philadelphia touchdown.
Well, John Wellborn, he gets up on the linebacker level. Of course, John Ritchie also clears out LeVar Arrington. And a great job by those guys up front, giving Westbrook a lane. A lot of guys could have gotten in that hole.
Huge hole over the left side, and this big offensive line for the Eagles, which boasts three Pro Bowlers, opens it up. Westbrook in, and a comfortable lead for the Eagles.
Her inspiration is a light, and it's burning bright. The taste of Dr. Pepper.
Disposable razors, but now there's new Sensor 3 from Gillette. Totally new handle, three blades, on springs that adjust to your face. No disposable shaves better. It could be the best disposable you ever threw away. New Gillette Sensor 3.
Someone's threatening to initiate an outbreak of a very deadly virus.
This fall,
the damage to this country would be catastrophic.
Hold your breath.
They found a body that's been infected.
We have 2 hours before they release the virus.
But don't negotiate with terrorists.
Because this time,
open the door!
The terror is contagious.
Just do it now!
What happens next is on you, Jack!
The season premiere of 24, Tuesday, October 28th on Fox. Presented without commercial interruption by the next Ford F-150.
Talk about Westbrook giving this Eagles team a burst. He did from 19 yards out, the Villanova grad. And it's an 11-point lead for the Philadelphia Eagles as Akers kicks it away. Morton. Redskins need a big return. Morton trying to give it to him. Out across the 30, marked down at the 33. Tyrell Harrison is there to make the stop after a 31-yard return. And early game headliners, week five, Stephen Davis for the still undefeated Carolina Panthers. And how about the start for the Kansas City Chiefs? And you can say the same for Chicago, getting their first victory as the Oakland Raiders' struggles continue.
I think Carolina is a team that's going to be there all season long. They started hot last season and faded. But that defense is just tremendous.
On first down, Ramsey dumps it off. Lavernius Coles trying to get to the sideline, and he does.
You know, we've been talking about the job that this defensive secondary's been doing for Philadelphia both last week and then again today. And I know there's a lot of NFC coaches around the league that are looking at these young players and wondering just how good are they going to be, and are they going to be the type of players that the Eagles drafted them to be? Because if they are, then this defense is going to be set for a lot of years to come. I mean, Bobby Taylor and Troy Vincent, the job that they've done, it's all based on the play of these corners.
More movement. Look like they got Dockery.
Offense, number 66. 5-yard penalty, still second down.
6 false start penalties, a problem they had with 3 of them at home last week.
And for Derek Dockery, an extremely tough day today. It was Dave Fiore could have played in this game. There's no question he could have. The decision was made to try and hold him out, try and get him right for next week, and it was a costly one today.
Second down and 7. Four-man rush, and the pass is complete to Gardner. And he is sandwiched 2 yards shy of a first down.
But for my money, and yes, this secondary's played very well, but the ability of this front seven to hold up against the run and to get pressure on the passer without having to bring help out of the secondary really has been the story.
Third down and two. And the pass complete, Liddell Betts. And he's got a first down inside Philadelphia territory.
And ND Kalu, he's back there in coverage. He's primarily a third down pass rusher, and he had to play a little bit more in previous games also because of the injuries to this defensive front.
Coming up on the 2-minute warning. Ramsey over the middle, Betts again. Makes the catch, gets a first down, and that will take us to the 2-minute warning. 1:57 left here in Philadelphia. Washington on the move. They have two timeouts left. They're down 11.
Fox NFL Sunday is brought to you by Bud Light. For the great taste that won't fill you up and never lets you down, make it a Bud Light.
What you doing, Brian?
Oh, I'm just putting my name and address in these bottles and sending them out to sea. Hopefully someone will find them and contact me someday.
Wow.
Yeah, wow.
Why? Why do you torture me, Brian Henderson of 12 Maple Leaf?
For the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
Brian! Nice to meet you.
Hard to make the best wireless network even better.
Can you hear me now? Good.
Everyone starts to notice. Verizon Wireless. We never stop working for you.
With our statistician, Ed Spita, Philadelphia's very own, and Dave Schwabe, our spotter up here in the booth. Joe, Troy, and Chris, a minute 58 on the clock. An 11-point lead for the Philadelphia Eagles and the Redskins with a first down at Philadelphia's 36.
Oh, boy. Just call it, Patrick. Just call it and run it.
False start, offense, number 66, 5-yard penalty, it's first down.
Kind of pulling the little Peyton Manning Jr. act, and it ain't working.
Well, you can't. You can't in a loud stadium. You can't make those big guys sit there and try to hold it and anticipate the snap count. They've already shown this game that they cannot hang in there, get up there and snap the ball.
First and 15. Ramsey stays on his feet, fires, and incomplete. Pulls the intended receiver.
I think he was over the line. Nobody's making that call, but it looked like he was a good yard beyond where the line of scrimmage was when he made that throw.
We'd like to welcome those of you watching the San Francisco 49ers take care of Detroit. Steve Mariucci's return to the city by the bay, a 7-point victory. Here is our game summary. McNabb, Ramsey, the sort of day he's had. ND Kalu with a huge interception return for a touchdown. Down by 11, number 11, scrambles and hits Betts, who is hit immediately by Sheldon Brown. That'll bring up third down.
And really the two best moments this offense has had for the Washington Redskins has been when they've been in this 2-minute offense. Unfortunately, because of the 2-minute warning and all that, they had to sort of stop and go, and that's when the momentum was broken.
Third down and 9. Ramsey over the middle. It's knocked down by Hollis Thomas.
I think you have to kick a field goal right here.
That would get the game to within eight, as opposed to going for it all here on fourth down and long. Eagles come with a zone dog. That's why Hollis Thomas is dropping off into coverage, able to get a hand on the ball. Well, now, Chris, what you brought up, it's like the Redskins weren't ready for it. They have to burn a timeout with the clock stopped and bring on the field goal unit because they weren't ready for that situation.
And that's a big mistake with the timeouts being limited, and you've got to anticipate an incomplete pass and where you are on the field. It's a two possession game. You can try the onside kick, and I always thought it was a lot easier to try the Hail Marys at the end of the game. You know, why not just take it and throw it down the field and you've got some sort of a shot. But you're right, Joe, it cost them a big timeout there.
Well, at least it only won. Yeah, and if you kick the field goal here and you make it, you at least keep the pressure on the Eagles. But then it begs to ask the question, with what just happened, when your head coach is also the offensive coordinator calling the plays, and we've seen it with some other teams, is there anybody over there on the sidelines making Steve Spurrier aware of the situations that he's in? And in the event you don't get the first down on third down, then kick the field goal. I'm not so sure anybody even reminded him, and that's why they had to burn the timeout.
You know, we've talked about this before, but I always thought, especially in this situation, when you've got a head coach calling the plays, you almost need a bench coach, a guy that just is studying situations and keeping them fresh in the head coach's mind.
53-yard try. The career long for Hall is 55 yards. Good snap, good hold. The kick is good, and the game is still alive. This makes it an 8-point game, just a laser line drive through the uprights by John Hall.
And from that distance, you can understand it, but he's been kicking lasers even when they've been short distances.
Tell you what, they didn't do too bad a job raiding the Jets this year, did they? They got some players out of those guys, Lavernius Coles and Chad Morton and John Hall, Randy Thomas.
How about the difference it's made on the other side with the Jets?
Doing
They're
nothing.
Off this week, 0-4 to start the season. And now with one timeout left, it is onside kick time for the Washington Redskins.
Well, whatever happens in this game, and if the Redskins go on to lose this game, obviously Steve Spurrier and this staff and these group of players are going to be disappointed. But in talking with Steve Spurrier last night, he said that when we played Philadelphia last year, they just blew us out in both games. And we've got to do a better job moving the football, something that they had not been able to do. He's got to at least feel better that they played him a lot closer this year, because they're still the big kids on the block. And they're the defending divisional champs, and they've got to go through Philadelphia if they're going to ultimately get where they want to go, and understand that Philadelphia did it without it, with a lot of guys hurt. A lot of guys hadn't played today, but still.
These two teams will go at each other again the final weekend of the season in Washington.
What the heck? I've never seen this one.
Up into the air, and it's recovered by the Washington Redskins.
How about that?
Bryan Johnson, the starting fullback, comes away with it, and the Redskins are still alive.
That ball was lying almost flat on the ground, and watch it take the double hop. Here it comes. This is what the kicker's trying to do, get the second hop to kick straight up in the air. There was some
discussion. The kicking team recovered the ball. Washington's ball, first down.
The officials got together, I think, to figure out if it went 10 yards. It definitely went 10 yards. And the Redskins take the football with a chance to go down the field, down by eight.
Well, there was nobody from the Eagles that really made an attempt to go after the ball.
That's a great point, Troy. I tell you, that with the game on the line, that play is a game over type situation.
Of course, they've got their hands team in there, and
I just have never seen a kicker do it like that. Have you seen that one before?
I haven't seen it, but I think we might start seeing a lot more of it.
Great effort by Bryan Johnson.
Well, now it comes into play just how big that called timeout that they had to use in order to get the field goal team on the field. Now they've got one timeout left.
starting with it at their own 43.
It looks like blitz right here, too.
Well, when Jim Johnson's back's against the wall, this is what he goes to. And now we're going to have another conversation. We're inside 2 minutes, so if there is some sort of challenge, it would be a booth review. And you can see Ed Hockley is not happy at all.
Wonder if Jim Johnson will come back and change his play now. It looked like they sort of tipped their hand that they were going to go blitz. Ramsey got his guys back in the huddle. Don't think he changed the call.
And whatever the officials had to get together to talk about, a clock issue, whatever, it's straightened out. Ramsey fires wide open on the near sideline as Patrick Johnson. He makes a move and hops out of bounds just inside Philadelphia territory with 1:08 remaining.
And Patrick Johnson almost made a mistake there. He caught the ball and then turned into the field of play. Didn't get a whole lot more yards out of it. Had he been tackled in bounds, that would have been a crucial mistake.
The shotgun is helping Ramsey, though, with the blitz. I think it's given him a little bit more of a chance to read it. He saw that one coming and went to the right side. When you blitz to the right, you throw to the right.
Fake handoff. Ramsey fires down the middle, wide open McCants, and he drops it. He started to look behind him before he made the catch, wondering where he was going with it, and he never brought it in.
Joe, Darnerien McCants has made some big plays already in this game, but they're in field goal range. If he's able to catch that one, the Eagles only come with a three-man rush. They're dropping eight guys, trying to find seams down the field. With eight guys being dropped into pass coverage is difficult, but McCants is not going to get a better opportunity than that to get this team in a position to win the game.
They've got to get the ball into the end zone and convert a two-point conversion. Third down and two, trying to get the first down. It's Coles making a move, and he picks up a fresh set of downs for the Washington Redskins.
But again, now without that timeout, and they burned one earlier as well
on the review,
on the challenge. So two timeouts that weren't used at all for this offense coming back to haunt them.
Ramsey over the middle. Morton out of the backfield makes a move, a first down inside the 35. And the Redskins, with Ramsey looking over to the sideline, they're going to get up and spike it. They better hurry if they're going to spike it. Oh, no, they're not. Dropping back to throw as Ramsey steps up down the middle. Has a man, McCants, for a touchdown. And with 13 seconds remaining, the Washington Redskins are a two-point conversion away from tying this game.
Joe Buck, I think your feeling was the same thing the Eagles were thinking. I think they thought they were going to come up and spike the football. The defense relaxed and allowed McCants to run right by everybody. This is a two zone. There's all kinds of guys playing right down the middle of the field. There's no way you should be able to get this thing in there.
Well, he just levels off. Ike Reese levels off, and you're right. As a backer, you've got to know, you've got to get down the middle of the field. That's the weakness in that coverage. And no one's able to get there. The safeties were out wide. They can't squeeze it. And Ike Reese in that linebacker level, they did not get back and cover the guy running down the center.
They just fell asleep. I really think they were going up to spike the football, and it just shocked them. What a great job by Ramsey, though. You talked about it, Troy. This young kid has a lot of poise, and they've been in a lot of these close games, and they know how to handle it.
Hard to believe, guys, that they would. They did all that without having to use a timeout. So now they get a chance to call a timeout, talk about what they want to do. They spend their final timeout, and they will try to get it in from the 2-yard line to tie this game.
That's a great point, Joe, being able to do that without burning the timeout. And then also, how about Patrick Ramsey?
I mean, this guy had been struggling throughout the entire game, had not thrown the ball well, had had some critical interceptions, and yet when the game's on the line, like he has shown, he's got tremendous poise for a second-year player to put this team in a position to tie this ball game.
But he needs one more.
One for one on two-point conversions of the Redskins this year.
Comes the blitz. Got him.
Wide open, but overthrown as Coles.
Yeah, he had him. He had him all right.
Oh, he had him wide open.
It'll stay 27-25, and the Redskins will have to kick off again. A little surprising that Lavernius Coles, their number one receiver, would get this open on a two-play conversion, but he was.
Looked like they just crossed the wide receivers in man coverage, had a perfect pick, and it's not an illegal play. And that is just all on Patrick Ramsey. That is just a blown throw. As well as he has played and bringing this team back, that's got to be an Emmy, gimme for a professional quarterback. Wow.
Well, as it is, now you're in a position where you've got to try another onside kick.
Oh, my. I mean, that's like missing a six-inch putt right there to win the U.S. Open.
Six-inch putt with guys coming after you on a blitz.
They do that in golf, though.
They may. Not sure if they do, but.
Well, you don't get more wide open than that in the NFL. I know that.
13 seconds remaining. No timeouts left for the Washington Redskins. And that same look at the football as Hall will try to get it again. And then they could have one play to get into field goal range. Takes a hop. And this time it's Mitchell who comes down with it for Philadelphia. For some reason, he gets up and tries to advance the ball. But the Eagles will take over, and with 11 seconds left, one snap away from their first victory at their new home stadium.
Well, there's one good story that comes out of all this. In the week of Rush Limbaugh, Donovan McNabb gets a win. And, you know, if anybody ever deserved a win, it would be this guy this week. And I've got to say, for James Brown in our studio, I thought he said it about as well as it could be said today during the course of the pregame show, that, you know, he felt like that we were all moving forward, and why in the world would anybody want to take us back?
The Eagles will snap the ball and walk off the field with a victory. And Philadelphia will move to 2-2 on the season. The Redskins 3-2, and you can hear the officials reminding them to play like professionals and not do anything after the final whistle. Andy Reid and the Philadelphia Eagles get their first victory here in their new home. A two-point win over the Washington Redskins. We'll all be back right after this.
Introducing Wendy's Homestyle Chicken Strips.
Heaven, I'm in heaven.
Three delicious pieces of breast fillet with your choice of Heartland Ranch, deli honey mustard, and spicy Southwest Chipotle. When it comes to chicken strips, Wendy's has a better way. Our new homestyle chicken strips. It's better here.
I know what I'm having for lunch.
And remember, you can eat great even late.
Sunday, Sunday, see Big Eddie haul trees in his fuel-injected Hemi Dodge Ram 1500. Sunday, Sunday, Big Eddie picks up stuff in his 345-horsepower Hemi Dodge Ram. Sunday, Sunday, going fishing in a Hemi-powered Ram.
Morning, Ed.
Monday, Monday!
You gotta stop.
On the road and stuck trying to get business email in all the wrong places? Get Verizon Wireless email access and your data will travel on America's most reliable wireless network.
Can you hear me now? Good.
For all your company's wireless needs, we mean business. Verizon Wireless. We never stop working for you.
Tell me about your dream.
It's like a movie. There's a sword and a stone.
Behold Excalibur.
A magic cost-cutting sword.
A magic cost-cutting sword.
But it's stuck. We can't get it out. What does it mean?
Perhaps there are no more costs to cut. Perhaps you should be...
King Arthur?
More productive.
Sorry.
It got interesting at the end. It ends up a two-point victory for the Philadelphia Eagles. Our UPS leaderboard brought to you by UPS. See what Brown can do for you. Donovan McNabb in his day at quarterback. The end of a long week. Westbrook, Darnerien McCants, the wide receiver, into the end zone for the final points of the day as the Redskins come up 2 points shy. And now the Wachovia uncommon perspective. We look at the first down run and lunge by Donovan McNabb. This uncommon perspective brought to you by Wachovia. Together we can achieve uncommon results. For all of us in Philadelphia, as the Eagles are back to the 500 mark at 2-2, the Redskins lose on the road. These two teams will meet again the final weekend of the regular season. The Eagles get their first victory in their new home, a hard-fought win over the Washington Redskins.